And, you know, even though they got themselves in rhythm, that second quarter just got him on pace. If that game had been close, he would have gotten 30 assists in that ball game.
I
no doubt about it.
Stoudemire, the last time these two met, had 30 points in the ball game. Here comes Jameer Nelson. He is going to be their point guard, they feel, for many, many years. His third year out of St. Joseph's. He's had some very good games for him. Had a high of 29 points at one time. Hedo Turkoglu dumps it in to the man-child, if you will. Dwight Howard, he muscles up, can't get it, and Amar comes down with a rebound.
And believe me, Howard, even though you play a lot of NBA games and you tend to want to forget your bad ones, he remembers what happened to him a while ago against the Suns. It was an embarrassing moment. He couldn't stay on the floor.
He was on that floor 19 minutes, had 4 points and 3 rebounds, and fouled out of the game. Here's Amari missing his shot, but he comes down to the rebound, brings it out to Nelson. Nelson played on that St. Joseph's team that was 27-0 in the regular season. They went to the Elite Eight that year. He's only 6 foot, but they love his leadership, and they like that three.
Yeah, well, one thing defensively you never do is leave the guy with the ball. Jameer Nelson was like, okay.
And so, striking first will be the magic. There's Nash trying to thread the needle, stolen by Nelson. Nelson with Amari behind him, and Amari lets him take it in, and Nelson scored the first 5 points of the game.
He did a smart thing. He cut off the avenue for Amari to take off in time his jump.
Nash outside now, tries to shake Nelson, goes in with a left hand, beautifully down. He didn't even use a glass on that one.
Tony Petit is like, wow. I mean, you know, he thought he was going to go glass. He just went on net.
I tell you, the degree of difficulty some of these Steve does is just off the charts. Here's Howard now against Amari, of course, grew up in Orlando, so he's always wanting to play well against the Magic. That's going to be a foul on Sean Marion inside. The last game you were talking about this, E.J., Dwight Howard got into foul trouble. Look at this, 19 minutes. That was a game he had just as soon forget, and he wants to redeem himself tonight.
Yeah, probably one of the worst games I've probably seen a player play in a long time because he didn't play smart. He picked up 2 fouls early, and he got back in, and he played as if he had 4. And he was too wired up, and he got himself in terrible foul trouble. He just never got into the rhythm of the game. And it made it easier for the Suns, no doubt about it.
Well, two nights ago, Howard had 30 points and 25 rebounds. He's had 4 20-20 games this year.
And he's doing it as a young man. Just remember, he has nowhere reached his peak. And at his peak, whenever that's going to happen, he is going to be downright unguardable because his offensive skills have continued to grow.
He's scary. He really is scary. 2 free throws by Tony Petit. Makes it 7-2. Nash, 3 ball. Got there. Rebound by Howard. Broken up by Amari. He picked his pocket. Goes up once. Can't get it to go. And eventually Grant Hill, the veteran. It was so good to see him back playing. He's gone through so much with his ankle surgeries. He had a sports hernia a year ago, played only 21 games, but he's back and playing well.
Yeah, that's why they're doing well, because of him. He's a stabilizer.
He is that, and so he's got great leadership. There's Nelson missing finally. Roger Bell comes back the other way. Nash penetrating, gets it to Sean Marion. Good ball movement, a three, and Roger Bell nails it. Proud to own the three-point zone. Fulton Holmes donates another $150 to Sun Charity.
You know, spacing is so important. Roger led the break, got into the paint, gave it up to Steve, and then got away from his defender to knock down the shot.
So Roger Bell able to make it a two-point game. Howard now with Stoudemire. Look at these two guys. Two great young players. That ball batted away. Howard not happy. He thought he should have gotten the foul call. Nash sets up Marion, and here we go. We're tied at 7.
You know, Hedo Turkoglu was running hard. And sometimes you might think guys aren't running hard when they're running trying to catch up with Sean Marion and Leandro Barbosa. Quite frankly, they are. They just can't run hard enough.
They're just running in concrete. Here it is. Turkoglu's had a very good, solid season. He's been battling the flu. Had an 18-point game last night. Here's Roger Bell, and Bell with another three. 2 for 2 behind the line. And Fulton Holmes proud to own the three-point zone. Another $150 check from Fulton Holmes to Suns Charities at tied at 10.
Yeah, need to keep an eye on Amari and Dwight Howard. They are really physical early on in this game. Dwight Howard last time down threw Amari to the floor, and Amari complained all the way up.
Nelson able to connect on a 2, makes it 12-10. Two big giants inside, and Nash is just a whirling dervish as he goes inside.
He dribbles so low to the floor, you can't steal it. And sometimes you reach, and when you reach, he's gone.
Well, I tell you, we always use the word great too much, but he is playing the game at a different level. No one's played point guard any better than he is right now. There's a reach-in foul going to go on Roger Bell. Let's go back to the last play by...
you know, he just splits the double team so well. And Tony Petit came out too wide, and that's what happens when you deal with a guy like Steve Nash. He's going to take what you give him, and he gave him a lift.
So Bell picks up his first foul. And the first Turk to play in the NBA, Hedo Turkoglu, who came in the league as a first-round pick of the Sacramento Kings. Phoenix Suns basketball is presented by Casino Arizona.
Hedo's a guy that I worry about. When you look at this team, because he's had a lot of success against the Suns. He's able to get his shot, and he finds good rhythm when he sees the Suns uniform.
He can really take a team on his shoulder shooting the ball. Not a good free throw shooting team is this Orlando team. They're 29th in the league. There, that ball is rejected inside. Nash driving in. Nelson comes back the other way inside. 8 minutes to go. The Magic with a two-point lead. Here is Grant Hill. He had a 20-point game last night. 8 of 11 against the Lakers. Kobe Bryant just took over that game late and won it for L.A. Nelson missing. Roger Bell comes down to the rebound. Ahead to Marion. Marion trying to make a pay, but the Magic get back this time. Bell looks at a three. Out it comes to Nash. Scissors a three. And the rebound is going to be ripped down by Batty.
Yes. Well, they're giving Steve shots, so he's going to have to take them. They're inviting him to shoot the ball from outside because they don't want him to get inside.
Wow, and he just got decked inside by Grant Hill. He and Hill had a collision inside. Nelson misses. Steve the other night against Cleveland took only 7 shots. He was 2 of 7 in the game. And, of course, those 21 assists overshadowed everything. Here's Diaw going in out to Amari. Amari, nice ball fake. They swing it out, 9 on the shot clock, and they'll reset. Nash trying to shake Nelson. Here comes Marion. He traveled with the ball. Orlando's a good defensive team. You look at them. They are top 10 in 7 different defensive categories, 3rd in scoring defense.
They have big bodies in there. I mean, you have Howard inside, and then Tony Petit is a very good defender as well as shot blocker. So, you know, they're front court guys. They're going to invite you to go to the basket.
So now it's still a 2-point lead for the Magic. Both teams shooting 50% here in the early going. Out it comes to Nelson, swings it out to Petit. Petit into Howard. Look at these two giants going against each other. Outside it comes. Grant Hill, a 2. And that'll go over the back, and the Suns will get the basketball. One of the things about Orlando is that they started to come on last year, Eddie. They finished the year 16-6, and all of a sudden decided, hey, we got a chance to be pretty good, and they are.
Yeah, they do. And I know Cleveland came in, and Steve knocks another one down. And everybody thought that they might be the class of the Eastern Conference, but I beg to differ. I think Orlando has played solid all year long, although 22-15. This is a bigger test for the Suns than Cleveland.
I agree with you. In it goes now, and there is Dwight Howard. He was the first guy to have a 20-20 game under the age of 20. Now, he's only, at this point of his career, 21 years old. 21 December 8th. I mean, the guy has an enormous upside.
Well, the scary thing about it all is Amari knocks it down. Is this guy was that big playing in high school. Can you imagine having your kid having to guard this guy in high school?
Not fair. It's not fair. And so it's tied at 16 now. Very interesting game here in the first quarter play. As this Magic team coming in here 22-15 on the year, 8-9 on the road. Turkoglu over the outstretched arm of Marion. Marion did such a good job on LeBron James. People say, well, they got over 30 points, but that was late when it was over. The verdict was already in. We have a foul now as we're going to take a break. 5:24. Let's take a look at Dwight Howard again, Eddie.
Well, the prototype player has arrived again. We had Karl Malone. Now we have Dwight Howard.
That was an awesome show.
Awesome.
Hey, would you mind?
No problem.
Me too. So, are you the bass player or the drummer?
I'm not in the band. I'm just here for the Bud Light. Who's Penn?
Johnny!
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
Who's Todd Schischler?
As you may have already heard, recently, the Maricopa County Attorney announced a new Get Tough policy for serious criminal cases. Plead to the most serious charge or go to trial. At Phillips & Associates, we understand that there's often a reasonable explanation or defense, and we believe that you are innocent until proven guilty. At Phillips & Associates, our experienced, aggressive trial attorneys can help you. Call now, 602-258-8888, or visit us online at phillipslaw.com.
He's one of the most feared enforcers in the NHL. But off the ice, this Coyote's kindness runs very deep.
I'm not this big fight person.
A revealing conversation with the real George LaRocque. In my own words, George LaRocque. Wednesday night at 6:30. Two of the most improved players in the country go toe-to-toe as Mustafa Shakur and the Wildcats battle Aaron Brooks and the Oregon Ducks. Then stay tuned for in-depth analysis of all the action on the Quest Wildcats Live postgame show. It all begins tomorrow at 6.
We're tied at 16 at the 5:24 mark of the first quarter. Four of the five Suns starters have scored thus far. Hey, Suns fans, head over to any of the seven local Valley Kia dealers from January 8th through February 4th and test drive a new Kia, and you'll receive a pair of Phoenix Suns tickets while supplies last. Log on to Suns.com for more information. Eddie, you said this. They're making Steve Nash take the shots after shooting only 7 against Cleveland the other night.
Yeah, I mean, Steve gets different looks. I mean, some teams will say, you know what, we need to try to stay at home and see if Steve is going to take 25 shots, or we have to help out and recover. And the help recover doesn't work. I mean, you know, I think you have to stay at home and just hope Steve sometimes gets tired of shooting. But he knows and he understands the game so well, he's going to take 20 shots if you continue to give it to him.
So we have changes now. Kurt Thomas and Leandro Barbosa coming in. Now, the Suns bench has really been good. They had 53 points the other night. In fact, the other night, Eddie, when Steve Nash went out, the Suns actually built their lead against Cleveland.
Yeah, and that's the good sign. You know, when Steve sits down, does this unit still continue to play well?
Here is Nash going inside, brings it back out to Marion, into the corner to Kurt Thomas. Thomas is going to hit his first shot of the night. Kurt the other night was shooting very well. He was 4 of 7 in that game.
That's his shot. And, you know, for young players watching, you get to your range and you produce. And that's what Kurt does. You never see him take shots anywhere else other than free throw line extended and on the baseline.
Suns with their first lead of the ball game, 18-16. Hill spin move, goes in. And here's a guy who went through 5 ankle surgeries in 4 years and coming back and playing, a 7-time All-Star, Grant Hill. Out it comes now to Nash. We're tied at 18, a 3 by Steve. Left to Jordan. Look at Amari. High into the air, soaring rebound. Stat really going out. And school was out when he went up for that one.
Well, no one was going to get it.
Nash going baseline. That'll be knocked out of bounds by the Magic. 14 to shoot.
And that's what Amari has been giving this team. I mean, you know, everybody's been waiting on the maturity factor to set in, and the year off has really helped him because he has given this team anything that they need to get the victory.
Here's Barbosa and his first shot of the night, and it's going to be tipped over to Marion, and the Suns on the second chance can't quite get it to go.
Yeah, Sean just pulled the string on that one. You can't complain. That's his normal shot. But sometimes you say, just slow down a little bit, but that's not him. You have to live with it.
John has 4 double-doubles in a row. I mean, his game has really picked up in the last 4 games. There's Howard missing. That's a 4th rebound of the night now for Stoudemire. Nash comes back the other way. He's left open, and he makes him pay.
Yeah, I think Howard's trying to prove a point. And I understand he had a very difficult game against Amari the last time out, and he has been very aggressive, and I'm sure that's their game plan. And their game plan against allowing Steve to shoot better change, because he is going to continue to knock him back.
He has 8 points in the ball game. Now he's hit 4 of 8. Turkaloo from outside. That's a 2. And we're tied up at 20. Nash signals the play as he comes across the timeline and goes in. And they're going to give him a continuation. No. He was fouled before the shot in the estimation of official Scott Foster. And now Darko Milicic will come in. Also, Keon Dooling will check in as they make their first changes of the night. Going out will be Batie and Jameer Nelson. And now another change as Carlos Arroyo will check in for Grant Hill.
Yeah, Dooling is almost a mirror image of Leandro. A little bit less, you know, but he can give them that type of scoring off of their bench.
I wouldn't trade him.
Oh, okay.
Here's Nash off to Amari. Amari trying to hit the baseline past him. Marion throws it away. And the Suns now have turned it over 3 times. We're tied at 20. This game, a real barometer for Orlando. This is their 3rd game of 4 on the road. They wanted to come out west and do well. They've done well on the road, 6-3 thus far against the Western Conference. As Dooling comes in, hits his first shot.
They do well because they're big. And they know that they can control the glass. And so they're going to give themselves opportunity to score or stay in the game, because they will get possession.
They're the number 1 rebounding team in the NBA, 2nd in offensive rebounds, to back up what EJ is saying. Magic up by two. Suns have it, 21 on the shot clock. You can see thus far, Suns 9 of 17, Magic 8 of 15. Tight-fisted game here in the early going. Nash searching for somebody to get open. Amari goes in and Dwight Howard reached in, batted it away, and committed the foul. So Dwight Howard, who got into foul trouble the first game, played only 19 minutes, has picked up his first of the night.
Yeah, and it'll be interesting to see if Amari tries to go at him on his next possession, because it'll be good to get him out. That's one of the keys, attack Howard.
Here's Howard coming out, now trying to get the ball out of Nash's hands, and he is bumped as he goes inside. Carlos Arroyo got a piece of him. And so we have a timeout, 2:53 to go in this first quarter. The Magic with the early lead, but it's a very, very close. Back and forth has been the lead.
The wait is over. Josh Groban returns live in an all-new show. March 25th at U.S. Airways Center. Tickets are on sale now. It's one unforgettable night in concert. Produced by Live Nation.
I really like this breakfast bistro sandwich. This bacon is great.
Well, you know, in Italy, bacon is called pancetta.
How do you know that?
As a guy, I pretty much know everything there is to know about bacon. It's encoded into our DNA at birth.
I have some things encoded on my DNA.
Oh, yeah?
Like I'm able to sense when you're just full of it.
Bacon breakfast bistro sandwich. Only bacon, eggs, and cheese on toasted ciabatta bread. Try one with a cranberry juice or any other juice, because Sonic is your ultimate drink stop.
Welcome back to Push the Right Button. All right, go ahead, Jim.
I gotta go with B, Bill.
Apparently you push the instant beach party button.
Yes! I love beaches.
Pretty groovy, but you should have pushed the spin button instead. Tell him why, Bob.
Jim, Casino Arizona slots pay out over $245,000 every hour, more than any other casino in Arizona.
Well, sorry about that. Thanks for playing. Bye-bye. All right, we'll see you next time.
Both teams shooting the ball very effectively at 53% here in the early going. Let's take a look at who's getting the job done. Brought to you by Jobbing.com. Local jobs, fresh jobs, real jobs. Find them on Jobbing.com. Well, Nash got it done Thursday night. 21 assists, an amazing game. Record time 14 in the first half. First player since Avery Johnson record two 20-assist games in one season.
Yeah, don't get tired of it. I mean, he's going to get it done again, no doubt about it, sooner or later. But he is just shooting the ball tonight. They're not playing up on him, and I think he might have a 30-point game tonight.
All right, you heard it. As Nash here in the early going has 8 points, 4 of 8, 2 assists. He just does what the team needs. He senses the moment. But James Jones is now coming in. Excuse me.
Yeah, it's tough to defend him when he does that, because, you know, you can't plan for him, because he understands the way that you play him is when he shoots. Against Cleveland, I mean, they were basically taking the ball out of his hands, and he was finding guys. So, I mean, that's what makes him great, and you're right. I mean, that word is used loosely, and that's why you save it for when it really means something. And that performance in the second quarter led by Nash was one of the greatest fast break performances I've seen in a long time.
Well, and, you know, the people in the East are watching that game, and everybody's talking about LeBron James and his MVP honors and how good the Cleveland team is. He made a statement. I mean, the eastern part of the country saw what we've been seeing all year in Steve Nash.
Yeah, and don't discredit the Suns' defense. I mean, LeBron had over 30 in that game, but a lot of those points came in garbage time.
That's exactly right. Here's Arroyo now bringing it out to Turkoglu. Turkoglu, a long three. And as Eddie mentioned, he can scare you with his range. He can shoot it. And the Magic now with a lead of 4.
He's 6'8". I mean, so you put a small guard on him, he's going to shoot right over the top.
Here's Nash now penetrating the two defenders and the ball battered away. Middlesex got a hand on it. And eventually Nash comes up with it. How in the world did he get the ball? They have 6 on the shot clock now. With 5, Nash will put it up and get it. What poise, what confidence.
And he smiled at Darko as he came out on. Darko didn't smile back. He was worried. He's like, I just don't want to get posterized here. I don't want to fall down.
So 11 points now for Steve Nash in 10 minutes. And there is Milicic, who was a bust in Detroit, but they have some high hopes for him. Darko Milicic, who was a number two pick in the draft.
He has talent, and I look for him to continue to grow. I thought Detroit didn't give him an opportunity because of the talent in the front court they had. But he's going to be a player.
From the corner, Marion, three ball. And for Thomas tries to keep it alive, Dwight Howard tracks it down. So Howard now with his first rebound, believe it or not, out of the ball game.
Well, don't worry about it. Before it's all said and done, he'd be in double figures.
I agree with you. He's averaging 12.8. That's leading the NBA. He could be the youngest player ever to lead the NBA in rebounding in the season. Ball deflected out. Here comes Nash the other way. Beautifully to Barbosa. And Dooling thought he was back, but he wasn't.
No, and that's the problem with Leandro. You think you have him, and all of a sudden, he just puts it in another gear, and he's gone.
So the Suns have tied it up inside a minute to go here in this first quarter. Entertaining game between what many people feel could be the best in the East, and the Suns right at the top of the West in the Wild West. That shot by Milicic missing. James Jones with a rebound.
Once he gets confident in that shot, I mean, he's almost unguardable. He's so long.
And how about Marion with a three? And Fulton Holmes fouled on the three-point zone. Another $150 check to Suns. Jerry's 3 of 7 now from three-point land.
Great teams go on runs. Even though they might be down, all of a sudden they're ahead at the end of the quarter.
And the Suns do that. And that's a very good point as Dooling now dumps it into Dwight Howard. Howard's been very quiet. 2 points and one rebound here. Dooling now gets a screen from Howard, and whoa, he rolled the shot that badly, and the shot clock expired. It didn't hit the rim. So the Suns will get it with 14 seconds left in this quarter.
Sean Marion normally does well. I mean, getting his hand in the passing lane. Steve Nash wiping off the hands a little bit so he can get the pass to Leandro for the layup.
Well, Marion came in here with 70 steals. You know, I was thinking about this at his start of the night. Sean Marion has 70 steals and 50 blocks. That's 120 plays this season where he has impacted the game.
Yeah, and people just don't pay attention to that part of it, and that's what makes him so special.
Here is Nash. How about that? There's a new shot. We haven't seen that one this year, I don't think.
He just comes out sometimes and just proves to people how good an offensive player he is.
And there is a long three by Royal. We've come to the end of the first quarter. And the Suns of one of those patented surges that they're so famous for. They are up 30 to 25. Nash with 13 points, an 8-0 run by the Suns, who are looking for their ninth win in a row.
The tests are completed. The results are in. The 2006 Kia Sedona is the first and only minivan to earn both the Insurance Institute's top safety pick and the government's 5-star crash safety rating in all 4 categories. The 2006 Kia Sedona, the highest safety-rated minivan ever built. Get $4,000 cash back. Visit your local Valley Kia retailers.
Don't miss the Room Store's incredible New Year's sale. Save up to 50% off and get no money down and no interest till New Year's 2011, or no money down, no interest, and no payments till July 2008. Save $487 on this suede cloth 7-piece living room, only $987. Save $427 on this contemporary 7-piece living room, only $1387. Or save $427 on this plush designer 7-piece living room, only $1687, on sale.
It's a slam dunk
at the Room Store.
Ends Tuesday.
Fulton Homes. You're proud to own, we're proud to build.
Flying to the LA area for business? If these 45 reasons don't convince you to fly Southwest Airlines nonstop to the LA area, maybe this will. With our internet specials, you can fly to the LA area for just $49 one way. Purchased by January 22nd.
You are now free to move about the country.
Phoenix Suns basketball presented by Casino Arizona is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, official airline of the NBA and your Phoenix Suns. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom. With Eddie Johnson, I'm Gary Bender. We played the first quarter. The Suns on an 8-0 run in the last 2:30. They have their biggest lead. Hey, check out special offers on Southwest.com for the latest and greatest in air, car, and hotel deals. Interesting, Eddie, after the first quarter, Stoudemire with 2 points, Howard with 2 points. Amari does have 4 rebounds to 1 for Dwight Howard.
Yeah, and so they're neutralizing one another, but the Suns need Amari to get back in his rhythm, no doubt about it.
James Jones has been shooting the ball so well. He's like a totally new guy since his shot has come back. Has hit 12 of his last 18 threes, misses that one. 30-25 the count. Dooley looking in, just underway in the second quarter. As this Orlando Magic team trying to get back to the playoffs. They last made it in 1996 when Shaquille O'Neal was in a Magic uniform. That ball deflected out. And with 4 to shoot now, Orlando will inbound the ball.
And, you know, that's another reason why James Jones is in the rotation. Not just his shooting, but his ability to play defense. I mean, he got a hand on that pass out, which if he had gotten there, it would have been a wide open shot.
Here's Howard now against Kurt Thomas. And that was a nice kiss off the glass. And so he has 4 points, 30-27. He's probably glad to have Amari out of there right now. He'd rather go against Kurt, even though Kurt is a very good defender. Here's Barbosa.
Just flies
around everybody. They kick it out to Marion. Here comes Thomas again. That ball was partially blocked. Howard got a piece of that. Went flying out and tipped it. Newland back the other way. Oh, Outlaw getting ready to come into the Magic attack. He didn't even play last night. That ball deflected out. 14 seconds, and here comes Charles Bow Outlaw. One of the most unusual people I've ever been around in my life.
And he walked onto the court like he's an outlaw. I mean, you know, all he needs is just the gun on the
wall. Yeah, he's a gunslinger, right?
No, he's not. Well, that's one thing. He's not going to shoot too well out here today.
Especially for the free throw line.
He might be a bricklayer.
Here's Arroyo going in, creating, and he draws a foul. That's on Marion. That would be his second. And that's who it is. So Sean has picked up two at the 10:52 mark. So Arroyo, who will go to line. Here's a guy that, you know, it looked like he had a long career ahead of him in Utah. For some reason, he and Jerry Sloan get along, so he ended up being traded around. And this guy's kind of a legend in Puerto Rico. He's a Michael Jordan of that country. Tonight's game is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, official airline of the NBA and your Phoenix Suns. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom.
You know, he's a good player, and that's why he continues to find jobs in the league, because they understand that. And he's played a very good role for this team. And I think they like what he does. And, you know, it's not surprising to see him out there in the fourth quarter closing the game.
Yep. His free throws make it a one-point game. Roger Bell for Diaw, who came in replacing Marion, who picked up his second foul. Thomas, as you said, Eddie, that's where he loves to shoot. Baseline on either side.
Yeah, and he gets there, and he doesn't do anything else. You know, he just gets to his spot, hoping that they can give him a good look.
4 points in the ball game now for Kurt Thomas. Suns up again by 3. They have led by as many as 5. Magic have also led by 5. Here's Dueling from outside. Short with a 3. Bow Outlaw at the back tap. And the lunch now by Keith Bogans, who just checked into the ballgame. Bogans, who last year played with the Bobcats and the Rockets out of Kentucky. He's a good shooter from outside, and he's tied it up with a 3.
Yeah, if he can stay healthy and stay on the floor, he can help him, because he has shown the ability to have some good offensive game.
There's Barbosa losing the handle. It will be off of Leandro. The Magic will have the basketball. That's 4 turnovers against the Suns. We're tied at 32. Suns trying to sweep the season series against the Magic after beating them earlier this year in December. Here is Arroyo, and Arroyo shot not going. Milicic with the rebound, the 7-footer putback, follows his own shot, and he's going to be fouled. Now, that's what you were talking about. Milicic playing with confidence, finding a place to play. He's fitting in with this team.
Well, if you wonder why he was taking number one, that's why. I mean, he's just all arms and legs, and he's 7 foot tall. And so if he just stretches out, a lot of times the ball is going to find its way back to him. And now it's just a matter of him getting his confidence and getting consistent looks. And credit Brian Hill and the coaching staff. They've really worked with him. You see his confidence starting to grow. And I like him. I think, you know, if the future continues to grow for him, I think he's going to be a very good player in this league.
He's gotten bigger. He is stronger than he used to be. He's going to be a restricted free agent at the end of the season. They did not extend his contract, but the way he's playing, they will be forced to do that.
Well, don't be surprised that he might get an offer sheet. There's a lot of teams out there would love to have him.
So Milicic gets one of two, and the Magic up by one, 33-32. Diaw, who's been averaging 7 assists a game in the last 4 games. Out it comes to Bell. Bell with a 3. In and out. Milicic with a rebound. Milicic is only 21 years old, and he's already coming into his 4th year in the league. Here is now Royal missing. James Jones with a rebound. So Stoudemire's back in the ball game, but Howard is still on the bench. You see the Magic hitting 50% here in the second quarter. James Jones is fouled. Bogan's got him, and so there'll be 3 free throws coming up on this one.
You know, James Jones drawing a lot of fouls from the perimeter because he's smart with his feet. And one of the things you do as a jump shooter, you see a defender trying to run by you, just kind of kick out your feet a little bit. You don't do it drastically because you can get an offensive foul. But do it enough to take the hit and then fall. A lot of times you find yourself at the line like James is right now.
Look at this, what he has done the last 5 games. Eddie, he says it's a leather ball, the old ball. All of a sudden, it started to come together for Junior. And the statistics back that up.
Shooters are quirky. I mean, you know, my biggest quirk was coming out, making sure the basket was aligned. I mean, I'd have him change it if it wasn't. So, you know, that's the problem with being a shooter. You get into this quirkiness of making sure everything is right. And for him, the leather ball was perfect.
I'm glad you're not quirky anymore.
Well, you know, every now and then the microphone is a little bit off center. I have to keep fiddling with
it. Here is Bogans now breaks it around. As the Suns now, are they jumping into a zone right now? As Royal goes to the far side, he is way short. And Boris Diaw comes down to the rebound ahead of Barbosa. Beautifully executed out. It comes to Bell. Barbosa, 3 from the corner. Count it. Barbosa just all over the place. And Fulton Holmes donates another $150 to Suns Charities. They're proud to own the 3-point zone.
And that's exactly what he is, Gary. I'm laughing because wasn't he the guy that led the break? All of a sudden he was behind the 3.
I know it. He's just absolutely, he's like the Roadrunner. Remember that? And the Roadrunner and the Coyote, he just beep, beep, he's gone.
Beep, beep.
What's going on, Sanchez?
It's Nelson, he's pruning.
Oh, come on, the game's on.
Get him out of there.
Welcome to the Bud Light Bunker, Nelson.
What do you guys do down here?
Nothing.
Sweet.
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
We got a bogey.
Get him out of there.
Do you need an experienced attorney to help you with a serious injury case? If so, remember Phillips & Associates and call right now. 1-800-706-3000. Serious injury lawyers ready to help you.
Dan. Kate, hi.
Look at you.
Hi.
You look great.
Oh, I love those earrings.
Oh, thank you. I love your shoes.
Oh, thanks. I just got them.
Oh,
and I love your belt.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Well, you can have it if I can have that back.
This back?
Yeah.
I don't think so. Hey. Hey, sweetie.
You can have a great tasting meal at McDonald's with premium chicken sandwiches for you and happy meals for the kids without sacrificing a thing. Prices and participation may vary.
Little or no money down and affordable payments to begin your DUI or criminal case. Call Phillips & Associates now to set up your free private consultation. 602-258-8888 or visit phillipslaw.com.
Suns using their speed. They have 9 fast break points here early in the ballgame. It's time for the Paddock Splashback. Sponsored by Paddock Pools, Patios, and Spas. March 9th, 1997. Phoenix guard Wesley Person hits 7 three-point shots as the Suns roll over the Magic by 36 points, the largest margin of victory in the Phoenix-Orlando series. Paddock Pools, Patios, and Spas for all your backyard needs.
Now, there's a guy that when he came in the league, and I saw the way that he shot the ball, the brother of the original Rifleman,
yep,
Chuck Person, that played with the Indiana Pacers a number of years and is an assistant coach for the Pacers right now. I really thought that he would have a long career, but a good one, because he can shoot the ball so well and just couldn't get it done over a period of time.
Yeah, he kind of drifted around, and here is Milicic on the play after the timeout, crashing inside, and it's a 38-35 game. I don't think I ever saw Milicic above the rim in his years, 2.5 years in Detroit. There's TL, that's it. Solid shot from outside.
Yeah, I think Boris has to start looking at the rim a little bit. They're backing off of him, just daring him to shoot the ball.
Tell you what, TL can struggle. They're in the zone again now as they bring it outside to Bogans. Bogans can be a zone buster into Bo Outlaw, and they were able to penetrate inside.
Yeah, well, Bo can hang around the paint. A very good finisher, right or left hand around the paint. You can't allow him to get that kind of position.
Now away from the ball, we're going to have a foul on Bo, who reached in on Boris TL. Eddie, are you surprised how long Dwight Howard's been on the bench?
Well, I think as long as the game is close, then I think he'll conserve him. And I think that's what he's trying to do because, he wants him fresh and not in foul trouble in the second half. I think that's key there. The Suns get some separation here. You'll see him in the game in a hurry.
Amari setting the screen for Diao. Diao can't get it. Amari tried to follow. Ball out of bounds and Outlaw's in the front row with the TV people. And he'll gather himself. The Suns will get it with 24 to shoot.
They're both very undersized. I mean, most players are going to outweigh him in the front line, so he has to do some dramatics in order to get the attention of the official.
Out it comes now to James Jones. 7:30 to go here in this first half. 40-37. Both teams have led by as many as five. Jones looked like he's going to take a three, and then we're going to have a blocking foul inside on Amari. Those are just wasted fouls. You hate to see Amari get those.
Yeah, but it's part of their offense, so you have to try. But the key thing is for the guy that has the ball, Gary, to not make his move until Amari is set, and that's the problem.
So Amari picks up his first foul. Out it comes now to Arroyo. Bogans, you can't let him shoot out there. He is a very good shooter. Fourth leading scorer in Kentucky Wildcat history, and he's tied it at 40. Bogans is one of those guys, as you said, has had trouble staying healthy, but he can shoot the ball. Here's Jones. This is a two by Junior, and he doesn't get the bounce.
Now, that's the difference between the old ball, well, not the old ball, the new old ball, and the leather ball, okay? Is the other ball early in the year would bounce three or four times and go in. The leather ball won't. It's definitive. If you don't put the right stroke on it, it's not going.
And here's Bogans. I understood everything you said. New, old, or whatever. Yeah. Here's Milicic, and he's going to be fouled by Jones. And Milicic right now is a factor in this game inside. As now Steve Nash is going to come back in for the Suns.
Well, the Suns always have problems with long guys that hang around the painted area. And Milicic is not going to venture out at all. I think their game plan is to try to attack the Suns inside. Why? Slows down tempo, obviously. And then, two, it creates their strength. Because their strength is to get to the free throw line more than you.
So Barbosa comes out, Nash comes in. Milicic, by the way, was the second pick in the draft in 2003. He was picked ahead of Carmelo Anthony. And LeBron James was the number one pick that year. So he had that stigma of, not delivering. And then Carmelo, of course, with the great career he has ahead of him.
It's not his fault he went number one because, Joe Dumars a good friend. He's done a great job in Detroit. But I think that if he had to do over again, he would have taken somebody else.
Yeah.
Maybe Carmelo.
Carmelo would have been a pretty good pick. Now, what do we got here? We've got a defensive technical. 3 seconds in the lane against Orlando, so Nash will shoot the technical. There's Brian Hill. He, for many years, was an assistant with Mike Fratello, who obviously is now out of Memphis. Grant Hill is coming in for the ball game. Hey, vote for your favorite Suns player for the 2007 NBA All-Star Game in Las Vegas. Log on to Suns.com and vote today. And the Suns hoping to have their staff there coaching the Western Conference All-Stars. 41-all with 6:11 to go here in this first half of play. Grant Hill comes out on Rajah Bell. Bell goes baseline, creates for Diao, Nash, and this is a three, and count it, shot clock expiring, and another $150 check from Fulton Homes of Suns Charities. They are proud to own the three-point zone.
Boy, you know that thing by heart.
I've got it down now. Eddie, as many threes as we hit, five of them tonight to be exact. Now it comes down to Arroyo, to Milicic, and Milicic is long. He is very effective, and Milicic here nearly going has 6 points.
And what else he's showing me is he's strong, because Amari is battling him, and he can't move it.
There's Diao. Nash swings around from the corner. Three ball, James Jones. And the rebound is going to be cleared by Grant Hill. And so the Magic down by one. You can see in the paint,
Milicic leading the way. The Magic getting the better of it with 14 points.
Well, tempo is slowed down, and this is not the way the Suns want to play. Orlando is a slow-down Eastern Conference team. They're getting the best of the Suns right now.
And so a pensive concern, Mike D'Antoni trying to keep this winning streak alive before they go on a two-game road swing.
Yeah, and let's see if we can get it going right now. Steve Nash has it going from deep. MVP.
When riding in California,
there are a few rules you should keep in mind.
If you invent it,
you name it.
The corduroy is not to be cruised,
but shredded,
orbited,
pounded into submission.
Always bring your sunscreen
and your party hat.
But the most important rule is
the rules don't apply.
After all, this is California.
Find yourself in California. Fly Southwest Airlines from Phoenix to Southern California for just $49 and to Northern California for just $109 to
$129. You are now free to move about the country.
You need some help?
Yeah. Could you give me a jump?
Sure.
Give it a try. Try giving it some gas. Thanks.
This week on ACC Sunday Night Hoops, can perennial power Duke prove they belong with the nation's best, or will Miami cast a spell and pull the upset? ACC Sunday Night Hoops, presented by Pizza Hut, this week on MSN.
Quest Sound Off Live, the most comprehensive coverage, interviews, and analysis of your Arizona teams. Tune in this Sunday as members of the local media weigh in on the hottest and most talked about news in Arizona sports. Quest Sound Off Live, Sunday night at 9:30.
Magic shooting 54% in this quarter. The Suns at 40%. After tonight's game, be sure to stick around for Quest Suns Live. Join Brad Steinke and TC Tom Chambers. They'll break down the highlights and take you inside the locker room for all the post-game reaction. That's Quest Suns Live right after the game. And Eddie, you made a good point a little bit ago. This game, tempo-wise, is exactly what the Magic wanted. They have really slowed it down.
Yeah, that's the kind of game that they feel like, well, most teams. I mean, they know they can't run with the Suns. And I think all the good teams in the league, they understand it to the point where they continue to try. A lot of times, weaker teams get caught up in it, and the Suns take advantage of them. The Suns are having a difficult time, Gary, in trying to really get this tempo up.
Yep. You saw Dwight Howard on the bench. He's only played in this ball game 13 minutes. Out it comes now to Rajah Bell. Hill jumps out on him, and they have impeded that shot. Here's Amari loading it up, and Stoudemire slamming it home.
You know, one of the key things in that, and for basketball players, you have to look. Amari wasn't content with standing behind Milicic. He went sideways and got himself in an area where if the ball did come off, he could get to it.
His hustle plays make a difference, don't they?
That's right.
And there's a steal by the guy who is tied for sixth in the league. And that's the third steal. 46-43. Nash with a three. Doesn't go this time. Grant Hill brings it down. Gets it off now to Arroyo. Carlos Arroyo played at Florida International. The same school of Rajah Bell. Off it comes now to Hill. Looking into Milicic. Now Dwight Howard getting ready to come back into the Magic lineup. Arroyo with eight on the shot clock. Milicic can't handle a pass. Five on the shot clock. Bogans with three, with two, and just got it off and it counts.
He's tough. I mean, like I said, I've seen him do this before, and he has a good offensive game.
There was an inbound problem there for the Suns. Bo Allo's hanging back, and they couldn't get the ball into Nash, and so Diallo alertly fired it half the way down the court to get it in. You can see what the Magic are doing. 7 of 12. They are hot. Here's Diallo. Takes Outlaw inside.
Yeah, again, just too strong for Bo. Anybody that Bo Allo guards in the front court will have an advantage on him.
48-45, the Suns. 3.5 minutes to go in this first half. Very interesting conclusion of this five-game homestand. And Milicic has made it very interesting for the Suns. He now has 8 points.
And everything is to his left. I think it's important for the Suns to maybe make him spin baseline to see what he has.
Well, the left-hander has the tendency, as you well know, they'll go left. And there is Diaw. That's a two. And Flores tonight has hit 3 of 4. I mean, he's barely rippled the net.
Yeah, well, who do you guard? I mean, that's the challenge the Suns present to any team that they play. And, boy, Diaw right now getting all the good looks.
Suns back up by three. Off it comes to Bogans. Off it, Grant Hill. Hill looking in with six on the shot clock. Elects to shoot it, and it's tipped out to Nash. Nash into the offensive end. Wheels it into the corner. Raja Bell with 2:43 left to go in this first half of play. Look at how long he almost fell over backwards. Dia with that pump fake. And now we've got a foul inside. And we're going to have a break in the action. That foul is going to be on Outlaw. Here is Stoudemire, a powerful move.
Yeah, the rebound by moving to the open area, and the stat man gets in rhythm.
I don't believe it.
Do you want to see a receipt?
Could be a forgery.
Forge a receipt to prove that my lunch costs less than yours.
Don't believe it.
The Big and Tasty Sandwich, for just a buck. One of the many great tastes on McDonald's Dollar Menu.
How's your bologna?
Prices and participation may vary.
This is the sound of a healthy heart. And so is this. And this. At Banner Health, experienced physicians keep more lives in rhythm with some of the most highly ranked heart care in the nation. Banner Health, leading the way in cardiac care so you can follow your heart.
Thank you very much, and welcome to the show where we push a button and see what happens. All right, go ahead, Kathy. Congratulations. You pushed the turn your boss into a baboon button. Interesting, but you should have pushed the spin button instead. Tell her why, Bob.
Kathy, Casino Arizona's slots pay out over $5.9 million every day. That's more than any other casino in Arizona.
Sorry, Kathy. Enjoy your lifetime supply of car wax. All right, we'll see you next time.
The fourth consecutive sellout here tonight, and of those, this would be the 19th in a row this season. So after the two-game road trip, here's what's on tap for the Phoenix Suns, brought to you by Bud Light. Refreshingly smooth Bud Light, always worth it. Upcoming Suns home games Friday against the Portland Blazers. Then the big ticket, Kevin Garnett and the T-Wolves on January 21st. San Antonio, February 1st in Utah, two of the best in the West. For tickets, call 800-4-NBA-TICKS or log on to suns.com. So now, Eddie, Howard is back. Dwight Howard comes in. He's played 13 minutes, 4 points, 1 rebound. Amari has 4 points and 6 rebounds.
Yeah, they pretty much negated each other, but I think that's still in the strength for the Suns, because the Suns will put more offensive power on the floor.
And as you mentioned, Howard will be rested to play most of that second half, I would think, after this back-to-back game. Orlando 6-2 in the second game of a back-to-back. Here is Bell, 3 on the shot clock. Oh, they don't have time to do that. As the shot clock expires, Diaz should have taken the shot. He didn't see the shot clock.
Yeah, but, you know, you see an example, though, of ball reversal. If the ball is moving, no matter how good the defense is, you're going to find eventually the open guy. Boris was the guy. He just got greedy and tried to make one more pass.
And so that's the unselfishness of this team as well. The great chemistry that they have. We mentioned Diaw in the last four games averaging 7 assists a game. So here we go with the Magic with the basketball and down by 3. Approaching 2 minutes left in this game in the first half. Arroyo doing a Steve Nash imitation, dribbling inside. Gets it into Middlesitz. Boris Diaw trying to guard the 7-footer. Kicks into the corner. Turkoglu is open. And the rebound is cleared by Amari, his 7th of the night. Yeah, brings it back out to Roger Bell. Bell thus far in the game with 6 points. Diaw slashes in. Oh, beautiful pirouette move. He had Milicic just flying by him.
Yeah, that's a good trick move that most young players can put on anyone, because momentum will take the defender out of bounds, where the offensive player knows what he's going to do, the jump stop and the nice hook.
4 of 5 now is Boris Diaw in the game. Middlesitz comes back, tries to power it in, can't get it. Amari with another rebound. Nash headed back the other way. Nash with four assists in the game. Make it five. And Sean Marion hammers it home.
That was a quick death. The Matrix.
That was faster than the speed of light, wasn't it? 54-47. Wow. That was impressive. Marion now with 7 points in the game. Suns shooting 56%. Magic dropped down a little bit at 47% for the game. Turkoglu into Dwight Howard, double teaming him. Arroyo traveled. Boy, we've had a lot of that tonight. A lot of guys getting the ball outside and shuffling those feet. Let's go back to that thunderous dunk.
I mean, his elevation is just so quick, and he did it based because Dwight Howard was there. And if anyone else had been there, he'd have took his time, but he had to go up quick to get it in, just in case Howard thought about blocking it.
47 seconds left in this first half. Suns finishing strong here in the first half. Amari floats and hits off the glass. Even Dwight Howard couldn't stop that one.
No, and momentum carried him away from the basket, which means you do kiss it off between the square, and that's the key there.
56-47 now. Inside it goes, and Howard answers at the other end. So this dunk fest may be getting now, as we have the top three dunkers in the NBA in this game tonight. Howard, Marion, and Amari. About 5 seconds difference between the game and the shot clock. 56-49, the Suns. Suns have led by as many as nine in the game. Here's Diaw inside. Amari! As I said, the dunk fest has started.
Yeah, and the penetration of Steve, and then he takes it to the second best assist man in Boris Diaw. You know he's going to find somebody.
58-49, and there's a foul on Diaw coming out to try to foul Arroyo. He had a foul to give, and so it'll go side out. Hey, coming up, it's a Ford Edge halftime report with Tom Leander and Tom Chambers out on the Bud Light Paseo. They'll have first half highlights and analysis, plus the Ford free throw giveaway. Stay tuned right here on FSN Arizona. Phoenix Suns basketball presented by Casino Arizona. Ball being deflected, and we have a foul on Amari, and Amari's picked up his second with 4 seconds left in this first half.
Yeah, and you know, he did a good job, but it's hard to get around Howard once he stations himself in the paint. And you know, either he was going to get the dunk or he would get fouled. So overall, I think it's a good play on Amari.
Dwight Howard is a very poor free throw shooter. Last night he was 7 of 16. That's the difference in that ball game last night, if you think about it.
Yeah, and it'll get better. I think it'll get better for him as he continues to make shots there. His form isn't that bad, but he's just experiencing so many things, so many pressure-packed things. He just can't get it all to go through. But I tell you what, the numbers that he's put up this year is just enough to overcome the poor free throw shooting.
When you look at him, Eddie, now you're a technician. His rotation's really good on this ball.
Well, yeah, I mean, his form is not that bad. I mean, obviously, he needs some correction and whatnot, maybe move the ball a little bit more to his right. But other than that, I think it's fine.
Here comes Marion the other way, deflected out. Hustle play that time by Orlando. 1.3 seconds left, at least showing on the clock, unless they change this, as they may put some time back on the clock. And there's a heads-up play by Orlando getting back defensively. So the three guys, Callahan, Foster, and Guthrie, are talking it over, and we'll have an explanation.
We're going to go eight tenths on this play right here.
Are they going to add it or take it down to eight tenths? I'll have it explained
math
to him.
Taking it down to eight tenths. Well, you can get a shot.
Yep.
Right. And .8, you can catch and shoot.
So a 20-second timeout is that's exactly what Mike D'Antoni's orchestrating right now. Try to find a play with eight tenths and try to build on your halftime lead. It's time for a breather. Brought to you by Arizona Department of Health Services, who encourages you to be tobacco-free. For information on how to quit smoking, call 800-556-6222 or visit ashline.org. Suns really have finished this first half well.
Yeah, they have, and you know, that's what they do. I mean, that's what I like about them this year than past, is that defensively they will shut you down and go on a run to get separation. And that's what the great championship teams have done in the past. And that's why you look at the Suns as being a contender, because of their ability to do just that.
They're on a 10-2 run to back up what we were just talking about. And it's 58-49, 8 tenths of a second left in a very, very interesting basketball game. So they get it in. time gets up. Is it going to count? Yes. They say he got it off. Now, Ryan Hill, he's not happy. John could not get the alley-oop, but he went back up with it and still got it. We're going to have another conference to see if this counts.
No, they're going to take that away. That will not count. I guarantee you that one.
Well, we come back. We'll let Tom and Tom explain what happened. We're at the break.
Come on, a pinata.
Just beat that mule.
Okay.
Hey, it's Bud Light.
It's a Bud Light pinata.
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
Here, it's the cake.
It's a Bud Light cake!
You know, Bob, driving around this state makes me realize how lucky we are.
As in win the lottery lucky or lucky in general lucky?
Well, both. See, over the last 25 years, your Arizona Lottery has generated nearly $2 billion to help fund statewide programs for our wildlife, parks, game and fish, small towns, and the CASA program for kids.
Wow, I think we need to get some scratchers tickets.
Right now?
Yeah, I'm feeling lucky.
Arizona Lottery.
It's more than just a game.
Don't miss the Room Store's incredible New Year's sale. Save up to 50% off and get no money down at no interest till New Year's 2011, or no money down, no interest, and no payments till July 2008. Save on this pillow top suede cloth sofa only $397, this plush contemporary sofa only $497, or this luxurious oversized nail head trimmed sofa only $597 on sale. The New Year's sale, now only at the Room Store.
It's a slam dunk.
At the Room Store.
Ends Tuesday.
Imagine your world without glasses. You don't have to. With over 25,000 LASIK procedures performed. At Schwartz Laser Eye Center, individual care is priority one. Each patient receives a private one-on-one consultation and eye exam with Dr. Schwartz. Offering a wide range of cutting-edge eye procedures, patients receive the customized medical treatment that's absolutely right for them. Call today to schedule your free LASIK evaluation. Glasses free and loving it. Dr. Jay Schwartz, your hometown team eye doctor.
It's the Ford Halftime Report on FSN Arizona. Brought to you by Phillips & Associates, Arizona's law firm. The Room Store, we put it all together and save you more at the Room Store. By Fulton Homes, you're proud to own, we're proud to build. The Arizona Department of Health Services, encouraging you to be tobacco free. And by Leslie Swimming Pool Supplies. Over 40 Valley locations, over 500 nationwide. Phoenix Suns basketball is presented by Casino Arizona. Now, back to the Ford Halftime Report.
Tom Leander along with Tom Chambers, two 30-point quarters for the Suns. I mean, the Suns are so fast, Tom Chambers, that Sean Marion can go up, tip the ball, come down, catch it, shoot, and point eight. It counts.
I'm telling you right there, that is sweet. You know, we always said he was quick. That was really quick.
How do you do that in point eight?
I don't know. I don't care. But you know what? I'm glad it's good. It's good.
Tom Leander along with the man wearing the golden hat.
I'm having a tough time here, but my ears are warm.
And again, what is that made out of for those that didn't join us on Suns Live?
This is Beaver. This is my beaver hat.
His beaver hat.
Yeah.
All right. Hey, Suns closing out the quarters. In the first quarter on a 9-0 run, they close out the first half on a 12-2 push.
Well, you know, the Suns are just, they don't ever surprise me. Steve Nash, the best playmaker in basketball, was the main reason this team really got it going, scoring all those points in the first quarter and having 17 at the half. But this Suns team, and you have to give credit to Orlando because they did a nice job of slowing him down, making him play their style of game. But there's just too many weapons out there to stop him for a long period of time. So to end up the half 12-2 tear like that, I love that play right there.
Dishing on a little punishment to Carlos Arroyo, 13 of his 17 points came in that first quarter. And how demoralizing is that for an opponent going back to their huddle at the end of the quarter or into the locker room, in this case, the Magic?
Well, you know, it's demoralizing somewhat, but mostly they've played the Suns pretty tight. This is bothering you, isn't it?
I'm all right with it. But they
played them pretty tight. That last little bit, coach is going to take them in there and say, hey, guys, just keep it tightened up, because you give them 2 minutes, and guess what they do? 12-2, so they won't do it this half.
Ford Fusion, Smart Money Magazine's best new car value. Check it out during Ford's year-end event.
Let's get it started.
Fusion's class-exclusive all-wheel drive, a premium navigation system, standard front side impact airbags, great mileage, and more, you'll know why the smart money is on Ford Fusion. Let's get it started. Now for a limited time, get $1,000 year-end bonus cash or lease a Fusion for just $199 a month at your Arizona Ford dealers.
Meet Ann Zawicki. Ann is the mother of three lovely children, though until a recent trip to McDonald's, didn't know it. It was fresh brewed premium roast coffee and a McGriddles that brought everything into life-affirming focus.
We're going to be late for school.
Ann couldn't be happier.
I'm a soccer mom. None of us play soccer. Hockey. Nope.
Start your morning with richer, bolder premium roast coffee and add a warm, tasty McGriddles. Wake up and smell your life.
Girls? Ballet?
The hottest show in Las Vegas is coming this February when the NBA stars gather on the same court. Get ready for the 2007 NBA All-Star Game in Las Vegas by voting daily for your favorite players on NBA.com. Vote now and enter the NBA All-Star Sweepstakes for a chance to win a trip to NBA All-Star 2007. Visit NBA.com for more information. Watch the 2007 NBA All-Star Game live from Las Vegas, February 18th, only on TNT.
Hey, welcome back, Thunder Dan. You planning on a comeback?
No, I'm just here for my weekly water test.
Leslie's makes owning a pool easy and fun. Find everything you need to keep your pool clean and clear all year round. And pool experts in every store.
Retirement suits me just fine. Thanks, Leslie's.
Leslie's Swimming Pool Supplies. Over 35 Valley locations, more than 500 stores nationwide.
Welcome back to Push the Right Button. Go ahead, Rosa. Apparently you pressed the Launch Your Ex-Husband button. Cool. But you should have pressed the spin button instead. Tell her why, Bob.
Rosa, Casino Arizona slots pay out over $122,000 every 30 minutes, more than any other casino in Arizona.
Sorry, Rosa, but I know you'll enjoy those decorative couch covers. All right, thanks for playing. See you next time.
It's the Ford Edge Halftime Report.
Hey, I'm toasty.
Zero.
I am toasty over
you
here.
You are toasty.
That's right, baby.
There you go. Tom Leander along with Tom Chambers. Hey, your key matchup in the pregame show, Amari and Dwight Howard, kind of quiet in the first half until late in the second quarter. But Dwight Howard right now has one rebound.
One rebound. By far the best rebounder in basketball. You know, he's just dominated the league, but he does not like playing against the Phoenix Suns. I don't know if it's Amari. I don't know if it's their quicker. I don't know what it is, but he really has struggled. You know, Amari's geared up to play against him tonight. He's out-rebounding by a pile. He's got 8 rebounds himself. So I'm just thinking that this is not Dwight's style, and maybe he's a little... Maybe he's a little intimidated by Amari. What do you think?
Wow.
Maybe?
I'm not going to say that to his face.
No.
No, we'll be here.
I'm up here.
The safety of all of our friends out
here.
Yeah. I love these numbers, though. 4 of 5, 4 of 6, 4 of 6. That's Diao, Marion, and Stoudemire. Suns as a team shooting 60% from the field.
It's unbelievable what they do. And Orlando is a good defensive team. They have to be because they don't score very many points. But, when you play the Suns, throw out all the stats.
I always thought this guy would look good in Suns colors. You don't agree?
Nah.
He don't?
Play here.
He
know. He can't play here.
Check out the capable and versatile compact SUV Ford Escape during Ford's year-end event. Let's get it started. Car-like handling, intelligent four-wheel drive, and Escape offers great features like power moonroof, premium sound, the luxury of leather, and no other SUV in America gives you better gas mileage. Now get an Escape with 0% financing for 36 months plus 1,000 bonus cash or take 3,000 cash back, only at your Arizona Ford dealers.
Don't miss the Room Store's incredible New Year's sale. Save up to 50% off and get no money down and no interest till New Year's 2011, or no money down, no interest, and no payments till July 2008. Save on this Euro-style 100% leather sofa in your choice of black, bone, or lipstick red, only $6.97 on sale. The New Year's sale, now only at the Room Store.
It's a slam dunk.
We put it all together and save you more at the Room Store.
Ends Tuesday.
Fulton Homes. You're proud to own, we're proud to build.
You can always spot Safe Auto Insurance customers. They love minimum coverage. 1-800-SAFE-AUTO. Minimum coverage for minimum budgets.
Congratulations! You've launched the Pink Slip virus. Your office is now infected. They'll soon trace it back to you. Good luck finding a new job.
Congratulations! Want to get away? Now you can. Just go to southwest.com for Southwest Airlines' $99 internet specials from Phoenix to select cities in the Northwest.
You are now free to move about the country.
Phoenix Suns basketball, presented by Casino Arizona, is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, official airline of the NBA and your Phoenix Suns. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom.
Phoenix Suns are definitely the best show on sneakers, going after win number 9 in a row. And get this, TC, speaking of sneakers, I hear Kevin McCabe's running in the Rock and Roll Marathon tomorrow.
I guarantee you he ain't going to run.
You just
he
said
took
it.
Three steps outside of a jog. He'd need oxygen, and he'll need one of those defibrillator things.
Defibrillator.
There you go.
I said I'm working the Rock and Roll. I'm emceeing it. Brad Steinke and Jody Jackson. I don't even like driving my car 26 miles. I wish them all best of luck. Early morning's going to be cold. We're down here. This
Clear.
Is the big one. The Bud Light Paseo for the Ford Halftime Free Throw Giveaway Contest. This is a chance to win a brand new Ford SEL 2000 car. Of course, one person randomly selected takes one free throw, make the shot, two free tickets to the Suns-Lakers game on April 13th. But, of course, they'll go into the hopper for the 2007 Edge SEL, the hottest car on the road from Ford. And my new best friend here is Robert Doyle, Suns season ticket holder. Robert, do you have an all-time favorite Suns player?
Tom Chambers.
Yeah!
Yes! Oh, wait, here you go. Let me give
Even
some
with the beaver hat?
Here we go. Who's your real son's favorite player?
Danny Ainge.
All right, Danny Ainge. Like Danny Ainge.
Throw something at him.
One shot here for a chance at a Ford SEL. Two Suns tickets to the Suns Lakers games. And a great. He's a winner already. He took home some.
Get up.
Ah!
Yeah, Robert. Way to go.
Even though you're qualified. Now give me the money back here. He likes Danny Ainge. Of course, we're here at halftime. Let's go back upstairs to Tom and Tom.
If he likes Danny Ainge, he's got to like Rajah Bell because they're making comparisons between
absolutely.
The two.
Absolutely. No, Rajah was tough. Danny was a whiner, man.
Are there times when you watch 3D Boris Diaw and you see magic? This was a magic-like move. Watch this as we head to the break.
I tell you what, I see a lot of magic. I'd like to play with this guy because he passes the ball all the time.
Watch this. Whoop! Oh, beauty! 3D!
There you go. There you go. Whoop!
Hey, sport.
Can I borrow the new Tacoma tonight?
My Tacoma. Sure.
Sweet.
I need you to fill out these liability forms, two forms of picture ID, proof of insurance, and a list of personal references. Never be too sure.
Seems like everyone wants to drive the Toyota Tacoma. Right now, get 3.9% financing on a rugged, adventurous 07 Tacoma. See your Valley Toyota dealers today.
Hey, welcome back, Thunder Dan. You planning on a comeback?
No, I'm just here for my weekly water test.
Leslie's makes owning a pool easy and fun. Find everything you need to keep your pool clean and clear all year round. And pool experts in every store.
Retirement suits me just fine. Thanks, Leslie's.
Leslie's Swimming Pool Supplies. Over 35 Valley locations, more than 500 stores nationwide.
Right now at the Room Store, save on all Broyhill during the factory-authorized Broyhill Bonus Bucks New Year's Sale. Buy $1,000 worth of Broyhill merchandise, get an extra $200 free. Buy $2,000, get $400 free. Buy $3,000, get $600 free. Or buy $5,000, get an extra $1,000 factory-authorized Broyhill Bonus Bucks. And get no money down and no interest till New Year's 2011. Or no money down, no interest, and no payments till July 2008.
It's a slam dunk.
At the Room Store.
Ends Tuesday.
All-night pet store. Got the idea from Jack. He says you got to offer your customers anything, anytime.
No sleeping.
A Jack in the Box, that might mean a burger for breakfast or French toast sticks at midnight. For me, it might be a poodle at 2 a.m.
Are you a laundromat?
No. Need a hamster?
Order anything on the menu anytime. From the guy who wrote the book.
This copyrighted telecast of the National Basketball Association may not be retransmitted, reproduced, rebroadcast, or otherwise distributed or used in any other form without the express written consent of the NBA.
Wardrobes for Suns broadcasters have been furnished by The Clothery in the Biltmore Fashion Park, voted Arizona's best men's store every year since 1998.
At the break, the Suns up by 11, the biggest lead of the ballgame with Eddie Johnson. I'm Gary Bender, and Eddie, a 12-2 finish to that first half. Just a little surge that you expect from the Suns, and it really, I think, surprised the Magic how this first half ended.
Well, if you look at the stats, it's really surprising. The Suns rebounded the basketball just as well and kept them off of the free throw line. Those are positives for the Magic. The Suns didn't allow it to happen. That's why they have control.
And they had 11 fast break points. Let's take a look now at inside the Jack in the Box box store. Well, we don't make it until you order it. See, the shooting is very good, 60%. And the fast break points, as mentioned, 11-2. That's huge.
Yeah, that really is, because, you know, the only way the Magic can compete in this game is to get some easy opportunities off turnovers or what have you. And the Suns have really taken care of that end of it. And the Magic are really trying to find their way. And if the Suns' bench start to heat up to match the effort of Orlando's bench, I think you might see a blowout here in the second half.
Well, Nash doing what they needed. Tonight it's points. The other night it was assists. And he just fills in where they're most needing. And the Suns now trying to win their ninth in a row and get ready for a two-game road swing to Memphis and Houston. This is a team that's unbeaten here in the year 2007. You look at this, Eddie, they have won 25 of the 27 games. I mean, this is a magnificent roll right now that this team is on.
It's amazing because, you know, it's hard to really understand it, but you just think about it. I mean, all the travel, all the practice, tired bodies, all the things that they go through, but yet when they get out here between the lines, they focus like not many teams do in this league. It is very difficult to maintain winning streaks like they have, and that's why Dallas and the Suns are the two best teams in the league, because they see the light. They're able to maintain good consistency over a period of time.
Let's go over now to Brad Steinke. Brad?
Thanks, guys. Just had a chance to talk with Suns assistant Phil Weber. Obviously, can't be too concerned when you shoot 60% and hold Dwight Howard to 6 points, but they know this Magic team is a team that's going to stick around. They've got to be concerned about allowing them to get inside. They'll be content letting the Magic take those three-pointers and win this getaway game before getting back out on the road. Back to you guys.
All right. Phil Weber, the guy that Brad was talking about. So we come back. You look at the lineups. It's the same five that opened for Orlando and likewise for the Suns. Here we go. Diaw brings it off to Stoudemire. Stoudemire with 8 points. Mellon doubly figures with 10. Goes outside against Dwight Howard.
You know, his shot is so smooth. I mean, you remember his first year. I mean, a line drive, didn't even have a chance. I mean, right now, his shooting form could be one of the tops in the league at his position.
It is really technically sound, as you well know. And it comes to Dwight Howard. He muscles it in at the other end. That was ending a 14-2 run with that basket by Howard inside. Howard now with 8 points in the ballgame. Here's Amari taking Howard inside, and he's going to draw the foul. The energy that Amari brings to the game, his defensive prowess lately. He had 5 blocks the other night. I mean, he's just done everything so very well for this team. And you look at the pace he's on, Eddie, he could end up with 47 double-doubles before this year is over. That's the pace he's on right now. Come explore the Verizon Wireless Jungle on level 4 of the U.S. Airways Center at all Suns home games. Tons of fun for the kids and adults alike. Verizon Wireless, it's the network. As Amari coming in tonight has 20 double-doubles.
That's consistency.
Yep.
And the block shots are starting to step up as well.
And they're going to call a foul. Now, Amari's had 3 fouls called on him. All of them have been really, I guess, tic-tac type things. And there's one you hate to see. Got one in the first half with 4 seconds left.
Well, you can't put your hand, both hands in the back of the post player. And that's what he did that time, and he got called.
That's his third. And there's Turkoglu with a reverse. Rebound is cleared by Roger Bell. Bell with 6 points of the game, now with 3 rebounds. Picking him up outside will be Grant Hill. Off to Amari. Can't quite handle the pass. Turkoglu digs it out. Turkoglu the other way. Marion goes for the steal and gets the foul instead. A lot of contact on that play, and Turkoglu just continued on up the floor.
Yeah, well, Amari didn't want to pick up his fourth foul, and so he allowed Turkoglu to get the angle on him, and once he got it, it was off and running.
This guy's been a double figure 17 times, now 18 counting tonight because he's already there with 10. Turkoglu, 27 years old, mentioned he came in the league as a first-round pick of the Kings, traded to the Spurs, spent a year with the Spurs, came over as a free agent to the Magic. And as you said, his three-point shooting can change a game.
Well, he has all the tools to be a 20-point-per-game scorer in the league. He and Mike Miller are two players that just baffle me because they have all the tools to be a 20-point scorer but just can't get it done with any consistency.
Yeah, brings it off to Bell now. Bell launches, and that is a two by Roger Bell. 66-53. Roger Bell now 3 of 5 for the night. Here it comes to Howard. Headed in low. There's Marion with another steal, averaging 2 steals a game. And he has 4 tonight. So he has 74 on the season. And now we're going to have inside a foul. Is that going to be on Stoudemire? I'm waiting for the indication who it's on. It is. Now, what was that, Eddie? I didn't see that at all. That's his 4th. Did you see it?
He was trying to set a screen. And it's no rhyme or reason. I mean, the Suns set a lot of screens. Coaches complain all the time. And after a while, they start to look at it. And, you would think that they would give a veteran like Amari the benefit of the doubt, knowing that he had 3 fouls, but he didn't.
Well, and, this is a game where you want your best guys out there on the floor to entertain everyone, TV and fans alike. And a foul like that just sends Amari to the bench now for some time. And sweeping inside is going to be Turkoglu, 66-55. Turkoglu with 14 points in the game. So the Suns that play without Amari for a stretch of time here. Off it comes to Roger Bell. Inside 10 seconds. Fouls like that, they just don't impact the game, I don't think. And there is Marion missing. Rebound by Grant Hill. Our guys in the truck, David Hughes and Bob Adlock, have found the foul. And we get a chance, we'll show it to you. I'm just really curious. The team brings it out now to Grant Hill. Swing it to Nelson. Good ball movement. 10 on the shot clock. Into Howard now against Kurt Thomas with a tough defensive effort. And the rebound by Dion. Good job by Kurt that time.
Yeah, and I think the Suns wouldn't mind Howard getting that type of touch. That's a tough shot to make. He's not that polished yet as an offensive player.
Speaking of polish, how about that polished pass to Boris Diaw?
Almost bounced out. Boris hesitated before he went back.
6 assists now for the leading assist guy in the league, averaging 11.3 a game. Hill swings it around to Turkoglu. 8:57 to go here in the third quarter. Turkoglu not able to get it to go off the glass. Nash with the rebound. The Suns trying to up-tempo. There's been times where the Magic has slowed it down. That is not going to slow down the Suns. A three. And Proud Home, the three-point zone is Fulton Home. $150 check to Suns Charities. And so 71-55.
See, Nash didn't think that ball was going in. Normally, he kind of backs away after a shot. He chased it down, and to his surprise, didn't hit nothing but rim. I mean, but net, excuse me.
Flying to the LA area for business? If these 45 reasons don't convince you to fly Southwest Airlines nonstop to the LA area, maybe this will. With our internet specials, you can fly to the LA area for just $49 one way. Purchased by January 22nd.
You are now free to move about the country.
Out in force and expect the max. That's what the state of Arizona is advertising when it comes to DUI. And at Phillips & Associates, we don't believe that's reasonable in all cases. Call 602-258-8888 now for an experienced, aggressive attorney.
Welcome back to Push the Right Button. All right, go ahead, Jim.
I gotta go with B, Bill.
Apparently you push the instant beach party button.
Yes. I love beaches.
Pretty groovy.
But you should have pushed the spin button instead. Tell him why, Bob.
Jim. Casino Arizona slots pay out over $245,000 every hour, more than any other casino in Arizona.
Well, sorry about that. Thanks for playing. Bye-bye.
All right, we'll see you next time.
If you've been charged with a serious crime, please remember Phillips & Associates. An experienced trial attorney can make a difference. Call us right now for a free private consultation. 1-800-706-3000.
Steve Nash now with 20 points after he buried that shot a moment ago, 71-55. ACC Sunday Night Hoops presented by Pizza Hut returns this week as the 11th-ranked Duke Blue Devils take on the upset-minded Miami Hurricanes. Coverage begins with the college basketball tip-off show tomorrow at 3 p.m. Mountain, right here on FSN Arizona. Eddie, we have gone back and looked at this fourth foul on Amari Stoudemire. Let's see what you think at the top of your screen.
Well, you know, it's a back screen for Sean Mary. And the only thing that I might say is he put both arms up high, and the reaction from Hedo is he bent over.
Yeah.
But that's a play that you see all the time. I mean, I don't know how you can make that call.
Well, it's a fourth foul, so Amari's on the bench now with 8:39 to go in the third. Grant Hill makes a move on Roger Bell. Hill has been very quiet. There's Howard, the leading rebounder, and the putback. Kurt Thomas got a piece of that.
He wanted to dunk it instead of just laying it up high off the glass.
Here's Diaw trying to create inside. Beautifully done for Sean Marion. Poetry in motion this time.
Well, the Sun's starting to run them out. Their ability to compete on the glass and keep them off the line has just made it very difficult for the Orlando Magic to stay in this game.
16 fast break points now for the Suns. 16-4 for the Magic. And there's Jameer Nelson hitting a three from outside. 73-58. They now have hit 6 of 11 behind the line. Suns 6 of 14 thus far. Out it comes to Thomas. Thomas getting a lot of minutes tonight due to the foul trouble to Amari Stoudemire. Off it comes to Kurt. Howard comes out on him. He got a piece of it. That's twice he's done that to
him. Yeah, a little head fake by Kurt will give him a clear opportunity to put a dribble down and knock it in.
Hill's going in, and he's able to force his way inside and score. He has 4 points in the game. He's only taken 5 shots in this game. Last night, he was 8 of 11 for 20 points against the Lakers. 34-year-old, 7-time All-Star. Marion, 3, count it! And crowned on the 3-point zone, Fulton Home. Another $150 check to Suns Charities. 16-point lead now. Suns have hit 7 of 15 behind the line. A turnover to Bell. Bell flips to the hole.
And Sean Marion did him credit. He got a hand on that pass. He should be credited for another kick.
Well, that would be 5 if that's in fact true. The Suns have exploded now. A 22nd timeout. And the Suns right now, Eddie, are running the Magic off the floor.
Yeah, because, again, the Magic has gotten into the Suns' tempo, and mainly because they're missing shots and they're not getting second opportunities, which means the Suns are going to get 2-on-1 and 3-on-1 fast break.
Let's take a look now at the Safe Auto breakaway of the game. There's been a few in this game, and it's the last one. 2 more fast break points.
Yeah, Sean Marion got a hand on it and see him get out in the lane, and Roger Bell with the speed as well gets it up and in.
And that play was made possible by minimum coverage by the defense. For minimum coverage you can really use, call 1-800-SAFE-AUTO. So the Suns have got the game back at the tempo they like. And thus far, they have outscored the Magic in this quarter, 18-11. And trying to win their 9th in a row, the longest winning streak right now in the NBA before they go on the 2-game road swing. Want to win this getaway game as Turkoglu outside now picked up by Marion. 10 on the shot clock. Milicic has come in, and Milicic has really had an impact in this game. He has 10 points, 5 rebounds.
He likes this rhythm. He is getting good post up without double teams, and he's finishing.
Bell makes up jumper. Count it. And Roger Bell now with 12 points. All 5 of the Suns starters now are in double figures. Little crossover by Nelson. And they have a foul called. They'll take it side out. It's going to be on Roger, or make it Steve Nash. So Nash has picked up his first personal foul of the night. Turkoglu will bring it in. Milicic from Serbia, Montenegro.
Nelson. In to Batee, and Batee, who doesn't shoot very much, more of a shot blocker defender, hits this shot.
But can't finish if you give him that opportunity. They just don't go to him.
They really don't. Batee has 4 points a game. You know, he didn't take a shot through the first 22-plus minutes last night against the Lakers, and then hit three in a row in the last 2 minutes. Here is Diaw with a two, and Marion over the back, blocked by Nelson.
That was a heck of a
run. Oh, man. Marion wanted a call, but Milicic got up there, it looked like. Here is Nelson. Nelson is able to hit a two, and it's 80-66.
Now, that was a heck of a block. If Sean Marion go back and look at the tape, I think he would agree.
Thomas set a big pick, and on a pick and roll, receives a pass from Nash, and he's fouled. Kurt Thomas really set the screen. Let's go back to that block.
I mean, Sean Marion first, kudos for the great offensive rebound, but that ball was still going up on the shot, and he got it on the way up. And, you know, that's the ability that this guy can have, and that's why he was the number one pick, just didn't get a chance to show it.
Barbosa comes into the game now, replacing Roger Bell. Backdoor man! Diaw with the assist.
He hesitated a little bit in the air, so he can get some really some force behind it.
Diaw now has a double-double, 10 points and 10 assists. That's going to be a foul on Sean Marion trying to guard Turkoglu. And at the 5:16 mark, Turkoglu will go to the free throw line. We got a change coming now for the Magic. Let's go back to that play you were talking about.
Yeah, I mean, just threw it up there. And Nelson really had no choice but to just get out of the way. And boys, Diaw, 5 rebounds from a triple-double.
Yes, and we all very well know he can do that. He had 4 last year and 1 this season. So coming in now is going to be Bo Outlaw. Batee will leave the ball game. James Jones now coming in for the Suns. 5:16 to go in this third quarter. Suns up 82-67. They led at half by 11. So Turkoglu able to get both free throws, and Turkoglu with 16 points in the game. Steve Nash with 20 points, 6 assists. Played 26 minutes of the game, brings it out to Jones. Jones is 0 for 3 in the first half. Thomas brings it off to Nash. Hill trying to fight through the picks. Diaw has it deflected, goes for it, saves it. 5 on the shot clock. Barbosa left to the mark.
Yeah, had to shoot it quick, had a defender running at him.
Jameer Nelson, a little crossover, and he'll go inside, and he's going to be fouled. Nelson's only 6 foot, but I tell you, he's got a huge heart, plays hard, and they think he's going to be their point guard for many, many years, as Bogans now will come into the lineup replacing Turkoglu.
We can get a replay of that and get Boris Diaw's expression after the foul. Now, he looks like the kid that was called out in school, but it was really the guy behind him that threw the paper.
Only you would know. You were throwing the spit wads
yes.
in high school
yeah,
or wherever, yeah. and they blamed it on somebody else,
but
right?
The expressions on his face, if you're an official, I mean, you feel like you wronged him. I mean...
So, wait a minute. That's they want to hold up the free throw here as Nelson hit the first one. 82-69. Nelson with 13 points in the game. He came in here averaging that. He has another free throw, and it's now a 12-point lead.
They're hanging around.
Yes, they are.
A lot of time left in this game.
They've won 5 of their last 6. They just couldn't quite finish with the Lakers last night. They did everything well except stop Kobe at the end. James Jones missing. High. They go for the rebound. Grant Hill landed very awkwardly. Out it comes now to Barbosa. James Jones. And he's fouled. Count it. James Jones hit the 3 and he's fouled by Nelson. A chance at a 4-point play.
Let me tell you what I like about that, Gary, is the fact that James Jones was 0 for 4. And, you know, it looked like he was getting back in that rhythm of losing confidence. He caught it again in the same possession and took it again, knocked it down. He's at the free throw line.
That is a 2. We stand corrected, not a 3, but it ends up a 3-point play. 85-70. Glad to see James Jones now start to find the mark again.
Yeah, you can't think about missing. He's had good looks, and I wondered if he would get back down himself, but he didn't.
There is Steve Nash fouling Nelson. We'll have Dooling coming back into the lineup now for the Magic. 15 foul against the Suns. And Grant Hill still shaking off that awkward fall. He's going to come out of the game. You just hope he's okay. He's had so much trouble with an ankle. Coach Mike D'Antoni's wardrobe is by Canale from the Clothery. The Clothery semi-annual sale is going on now at the Biltmore Fashion Park, 24th Street and Camelback. A belated Happy New Year to Greg and all the group down there.
Yeah. Greg's enjoying that iPod.
Did he get all those songs across?
I put a little music on.
Did you? Okay, I know he talked about it. How many can you put on there?
I put about 5,000 songs on there.
No.
Yeah. Makes me look good when I come to the game. Why not make him at least look good when he's listening to music?
And wearing those clothes from the Clothery.
Of course.
Okay, here is Bogans now. What kind of music did you put on, or you put on? You have everything.
I put his favorite music
on. Oh, okay.
I asked him what he likes.
Heavy metal, or was it?
Well, you know, he liked a little Guns N' Roses.
Nelson hits that 85. I doubt that.
He likes some MC Hammer, LL Cool J.
Okay, well, I can understand that, but I don't. 85-74. Here is Nash now. Have a little fun here at the ballpark. The Suns still haven't put this Magic team out of reach. They're still hanging around. Here's Jones, a long three. And the rebound tipped out now to Nelson. 3:42 to go in the third. Nelson's going to pull up again. He's got the hot hand right now. That's a three, and Nelson all of a sudden has 21 points.
You know, he's a young man that he's in the league with a chip on his shoulder. And when you deal with those players, we have one in Roger Bell. Yep. They come to play every night.
That's right. Great passion. So the Suns' 18-point lead is down now to 8. Here is Barbosa. That three won't go. Nice rebound by James Jones. That's the things that he can do. Play good team defense, rebound, and, of course, known for the three-point shot. Barbosa goes in, and they're going to call an offensive foul. Barbosa's basket will not count.
Well, you know, it's a bang-bang play, and sometimes as a player you can't argue because you get some and you get called. And right there, Leandro there, and, I mean, Nelson is there far above the circle, so it's an official. You know, the game is so quick, you're just looking at down at the floor to make sure he's in shape, and he was.
So Nelson is really kind of taking over this game right now, and he misses here. Rebound by Kurt Thomas. It's been Jameer Nelson that's really given them the spurt. Oh, speaking of spurts, Barbosa goaltending Charles Bo Outlaw. And before you knew what happened, Barbosa was at the other end.
And Dooling put his hand up like, you know, again, he got caught with his hand in the cookie jar to the coach and said, my fault. Yeah, you got to get back on Leandro. And I mean all the way back.
I don't know if that's possible, Eddie. I don't know if you can get back on Barbosa. They may be a physical improbability. 87-77. Suns have bumped it up to a double-digit lead again. Here is Nelson. Nelson with a two. He was on the line, and Nelson all of a sudden decided, I'm going to take over here.
Yeah, he's doing a LeBron James impersonation right now. He's just catching it and going.
His high was 29 this year. He's got 23 already here with 2.5 to go in the third. Dial blocks back. Nash fighting for the ball. Look at this hustle.
Look at that great offensive rebounder in there.
Wow, was that a great effort. Barbosa got it. Three. Another $150 check from Fulton Homes to Suns Charities. They're proud to own the three-point zone, and that is the eighth hit of the night.
You know players are watching scouting reports because Nelson, as he ran at Leandro, ran at him, he frowned. He knew he got beat.
And there's a pass inside it. Dooling and Dooling. Able to put that one up and make it a 90-81 game. You know, you look up and you think the Suns should be leading by more in this game, and yet it's only 90-81. We have a timeout.
Yeah, and Leandro off the bench doing what he does. Very effective. Bringing that spark. And Leandro from deep. Suns have a battle on their hands.
Hey, want a Bud Light?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Rubber floors. Just had them installed. Now we'll never break a Bud Light.
Oh, nice.
Remote.
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
Hi.
Too much bounce.
Maybe.
the Room Store's number one in sales and number one in selection of famous Sealy Posturepedic in Arizona. At the Room Store, you can buy it today. We'll deliver it tomorrow. We'll beat any price any day, and it all comes with our no-hassle, money-back satisfaction guarantee. Save $100 to $1,000 on Sealy Premium, Super Premium, and Ultra Premium mattress and mismatch box spring sets, and get no money down at no interest till New Year's 2011, or no money down, no interest, and no payments till July 2008.
It's a slam dunk.
At the Room Store.
Ends Tuesday.
Coming up after tonight's game on Quest Suns Live, all your game highlights and analysis. We'll break down the action and get an in-depth look at the keys to the game, plus players and coaches' reactions from the post-game news conference. Quest Suns Live, tonight after the Suns game.
Two of the most improved players in the country go toe-to-toe as Mustafa Shakur and the Wildcats battle Aaron Brooks and the Oregon Ducks. Then stay tuned for in-depth analysis of all the action on the Quest Wildcats Live post-game show. It all begins tomorrow at 6.
Suns up 90-81. They've led by as many as 18, but the Magic hanging around. Tonight's laser pass of the game, presented by Schwartz Laser Eye Centers, who urge you to see the best that you can see. The Suns have their eyes on the prize, and so should you. Visit SchwartzLaser.com for details. What's this pass now from Boris Diaw?
Just throw it up. Gary, you could have made that pass. Just throw it up. Sean will go get it. You can throw a curveball, and he'll go get it.
You know, in this quarter, Jameer Nelson has scored 16 points, 16 of his 23, and that's the reason, as you look at the double-double and possibly a triple-double tonight for Boris, the Suns can't really get any breathing room. Now, J.J. Redick was their first-round draft pick this year out of Duke, and 11th pick in the draft and not playing.
Yeah, and people wondered why he went that high. Well, he went that high because he could flat out shoot the basketball. And, you know, you envision him coming off screens and getting good looks, but for some reason, he just has not been able to get it going. Yes, injuries have played a part, but I think also learning the game and trying to fit in.
He's the all-time NCAA record holder for threes made in a career, 457, as the shot missing by Nelson. One of the things that he had problem with is a herniated disc in his back. So JJ wasn't able to play on the USA team, and I wonder how much of an impact that's had on his rookie year.
Well, I tell you what, he could play in a white uniform the way he can shoot the ball. Just run up and down and get good open looks.
Barbosa misses, and here they come, only down by 9. This Orlando team with 116 to go in this third quarter. They've been a good road team against the Western Conference. 6-3 at the start of the night, losing a tough one last night in the Staples Center. Milicic brings it out now to Doolin. Doolin shaking loose. And the rebound tipped up by Bo Outlaw, and then Kurt Thomas is able to wrap it up.
Yeah, that ball was all the way down.
And then Milicic picked him. He comes up with a steal. And a pass to Bogans, and Orlando continues to play hard.
Well, Milicic again hanging around in the backcourt, taking a page from Amari. That time got a hand on it.
Milicic is a player, no question about it. A guy who just languished on the bench in Detroit and now has found a place. There's Bo inside, battling, comes out of the rebound, and it is 7 points difference in the game, and the Magic can pull even closer.
Well, you know, in the third quarter of the Cleveland game, the Suns let up a little bit. Cleveland started to make a little run. Suns pushed them back. This time, the Magic, they've hung tight.
And it's been mainly Nelson that's brought him back. Bogans brings it into Milicic. Swings it out. Here's the guy we're talking about. This time does not get the shot to go. Diaw with the rebound. 8 seconds left in the quarter. 5 seconds. Inside, Barbosa. And he's going to be fouled with 5/10 of a second left. Milicic picks up the foul.
Yeah, no penalty right here, so it's a very good foul by Nelson.
So with 5/10, now the Suns were able to execute an 8/10 of a second for a basket at the end of the first half.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. You weren't convinced, I can tell.
No, I'm glad it counted.
Yeah, we'll take those two right now. Diaw brings it in, and that will not count and wouldn't go anyway. So the Magic outscore the Suns in the quarter, 34-30. Hang on, what a fourth quarter this should be. Suns trying to win their ninth in a row. The Magic trying to even their record for the year on the road at 9-9. 12 minutes left.
Two of the best in the NBA.
Can you help me with a washer and dryer?
Bob, could you help her?
What do you need?
A washer and dryer.
Go see Pam, 6 hours that way.
Yeah? A washer and dryer? I only know audio. Steve, can you help this lady?
At Spencer's, this will never happen to you. Our people are experts on all of our products, like Mitsubishi. Buy now and pay no interest until 2008.
Welcome to Spencer's.
I need a washer, dryer, big screen TV, and a mattress.
Sure, let's start over here.
Oh, the salad looks delicious.
Give me a large works pizza and a Coke.
But you're Cheesy Wally.
But that don't mean I gotta eat there.
At Peter Piper Pizza, you'll love the food as much as they love the fun. It's pandemonium. Try your favorite pizza on our fresh handmade pan pizza crust today. Crispy on the outside, soft and airy on the inside. Only at Peter Piper Pizza.
Pop quiz. What midsize SUV has a remarkably spacious interior, a class-leading warranty, a 5-star crash safety rating, and starts at just $15,865? Is it A, the rugged Kia Sorento, B, the tough Kia Sorento, C, the durable Kia Sorento, or D, all of the above? Correct! You picked the Kia Sorento. There really is no other choice. Hurry in and get $4,000 cash back on the comfortably refined Kia Sorento. To learn more, visit Kia.com.
When riding in California,
there are a few rules you should keep in mind.
If you invent it,
you name it.
The corduroy is not to be cruised.
But shredded.
Orbited.
Pounded into submission.
Always bring your sunscreen.
And your party hat.
But the most important rule is,
the rules don't apply.
After all, this is California.
Find yourself in California. Fly Southwest Airlines from Phoenix to Southern California for just $49. And to Northern California for just $109 to $129.
You are now free to move about the country.
Well, we have quite a game on our hands. 12 minutes to go. Suns turned the ball over 6 times in the third quarter, giving the Magic 8 points on those turnovers. Hey, Suns fans, join the Suns and national celebrities as they take to the court in support of Suns Charities for the 7th annual Jack in the Box Celebrity Shootout, presented by Robert and Carol Matches. That's tomorrow at 1 p.m. at the U.S. Airways Center. Get your tickets today at Ticketmaster.com, brought to you by KISS FM and FSN Arizona. So this Magic team showing some gritty determination, had trailed by as many as 18 in the game, have fought back, down by 7 as we go to the final quarter. Dueling from outside, rebound is cleared by Barbosa.
Well, thanks to Nelson, they found somebody to start a fight.
Yep.
And he did, and now he's just trying to find some help to go along with him.
16 points in that third quarter. You wonder when they bring Amari back. Amari's still on the bench with 4 fouls. He's played very few minutes, 21 to be exact. There's Dio Cannon, and he's fouled. Boris Dio tonight, Eddie, has been shooting so sweet. 6 of 9 now for 12 points.
Yeah, and they've been giving him looks all night. He probably should have taken at least 6 or 7 more shots, just not in his nature. That time, Nelson, just a tap on the elbow, and he's a shooter. He should know better. You can't hit a guy in that area. That's an automatic foul.
And that's a big foul. That's 5 fouls on Nelson. And Arroyo is going to come in, so that's one way to shut down Nelson, get him in foul trouble.
He guarded himself on that one.
And Dio cannot complete the 3-point play. Outlaw getting a lot of playing time here tonight. There's Jameer with 23 points, 5 fouls now. And he scored those 23 points in 21 minutes. 92-83. Arroyo coming in to relieve him. He's a very capable backup point guard. Dueling slashes in with a left hand. Very impressive. He's a good finisher. He's always been a good athlete.
You know, injuries has been his problem. I mean, when he was with the Clippers, I knew he would be a very good player.
A 3. Roger Bell hits a 3. The ninth time tonight that Fulton Holmes will write another $150 check and send it to Suns Charities. 95-85. Suns now by 10. Suns 9 of 21 behind the line. Arroyo with 5 on the shot clock. They pick up James Jones on the screen. Milicic in is fouled by Jones. Jones trying to fight through Milicic and ends up with the foul. That'll be his third.
You know, they played last night, so obviously Grant Hill is trying to at least maybe hopefully get close to where he can come back with Grant Hill and Dwight Howard maybe at the 7-minute mark and try to hope that they have some strength to finish up.
Out it comes now to Arroyo, and here is Keon Dooling, a play to Missouri, played 4 years with the Clippers, and you're going to have a foul called inside. It's going to be, I think, on Barbosa. There's a Bell. It's going to be Bell. Bell picking up the foul. So Bell now with his second.
Yeah, and the Suns have to be careful. They've done a good job of not allowing Orlando Magic to really live at the free throw line. And you don't want to get in the penalty early on in this quarter. That allows them not only to get to the line, but stop the clock as well.
Second team foul against the Suns. The Magic have one here in this fourth quarter. Arroyo's going to shoot it. And it looked to me like Jones got a piece of it.
He did. Long arms. Like I said, he's a very good defender, very deceptive, and always has his hands up to challenge the shot.
Barbosa brings it in to Boris. Diaw now with a double-double. He is three rebounds short of a triple-double. And we have a foul inside on Sean Marion. Eddie, I have tonight seen more fouls called away from the ball, which you just really don't even see them. Let's see if we can pick this one up.
Well, it all goes back to how a coach complains during the course of the game. And one of the things that coaches do complain about with teams like the Suns and the Mavericks is that they set moving screens. And so they start to pay attention to it, and Suns just have to be able to adjust.
So Marion sits down with five. Stoudemire with four comes into the game. So foul difficulty now starting to give the Suns some concern as they'll get it on the turnover now. That is nine turnovers against the Magic. Roger Bell, 15 points in the game. Really balanced scoring, led by Nash's 20. All the starters and double figures all have contributed. Here's a guy that's contributing. Barbosa with the three. Milicic comes out with the rebound. Barbosa is the sixth player on the Suns roster to be in double figures tonight. And we're going to have a moving screen on Milicic. So they're going to call on one end, call it on the other.
It's been pretty consistent now, you know, and guys trying to run screens on the move. And it's very difficult to guard NBA players anyway. And so if you're allowed to set moving screens, it's no way.
Two fouls on Milicic. He out. Very close to that triple-double. All he needs is three more rebounds. He goes in, and a sweeping one-hander. And now 14 points for 3D. 97-85. The count now. 9:16 to go in this fourth quarter. Suns looking for the ninth in a row.
Thank you very much, and welcome to the show where we push a button and see what happens. All right, go ahead, Kathy.
Congratulations. You pushed the turn your boss into a baboon button.
Interesting. But you should have pushed the spin button instead. Tell her why, Bob.
Kathy! Casino Arizona's slots pay out over $5.9 million every day. That's more than any other casino in Arizona.
Sorry, Kathy. Enjoy your lifetime supply of car wax. All right, we'll see you next time.
Right now at the Room Store, save on all Broyhill during the factory-authorized Broyhill Bonus Bucks New Year's Sale. Buy $1,000 worth of Broyhill merchandise, get an extra $200 free. Buy $2,000, get $400 free. Buy $3,000, get $600 free. Or buy $5,000, get an extra $1,000 factory-authorized Broyhill Bonus Bucks. And get no money down and no interest till New Year's 2011, or no money down, no interest, and no payments till July 2008.
It's a slam dunk.
At the Room Store.
Ends Tuesday.
When I was arrested for DUI, I needed a skilled, aggressive attorney. I searched online for the best attorneys in the Valley, and I found Phillips & Associates. I felt they were the most qualified for the job. They also offered an affordable payment plan, and as a student, that helped me a lot. If you need an attorney to represent you, please call Phillips & Associates. I'm glad I did.
Do you need an experienced law firm to go up against the government and protect your rights? Call Phillips & Associates now at 602-258-8888.
Phoenix Suns basketball, presented by Casino Arizona on FSN, is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, official airline of the NBA and your Phoenix Suns. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom. Jack in the Box, if we don't make it, do you order it? By Casino Arizona, are you pushing the right button? Schwartz Laser Eye Center, SchwartzLaser.com. See the best you can see. By Phillips & Associates, Arizona's law firm. And by Bud Light, refreshingly smooth Bud Light, always worth it. With Eddie Johnson, I'm Gary Bender. Our guys of the truck, David Hughes, Bob Adlock. Our team is ready to take you through the last 9:14 of this one. Suns now up by 12. They had had a cut down at 8 at one stage. The Magic trying to steal one here on the road. Off it comes to Milicic. Double team on him. Dooley now side 8 on the shot clock, and he just buried a 3.
Yeah, just wide open, though. Roger, you know, probably seeing if he can knock one down. Backed off a little bit, and Dooley. Okay.
Dooley now with 9 points. The turnover, and Dooley is going to now score 5 points in a row. And the Suns find themselves in a 7-point game and a lot of time left to go.
You can't be surprised by this here. This team is 22-15, and they've lost some close, tough games.
Yes, they have.
And they could be sitting here with only 10 losses. And so you have to respect them for 48 minutes.
So what do? You get Steve Nash back in the ballgame. He's reporting to the scorer's table now. Amari going inside. Amari been pretty ineffective here tonight because of foul trouble. So now, here comes Nash. James Jones will check out, and Nash with 20 points, 7 assists, comes in at the 8:22 mark.
Yeah, normally when he comes in, he makes something happen right away. He knows how to take the heart out of a team that's trying to get back in.
As we've said so many times, he senses the moment, and going to have 3 seconds in the lane. No, going to have a blocking foul on Boris Diaw. Another one of those blocking fouls. They've been calling them tonight, haven't they?
Yeah, but one of the pressures of being at this level of play in the NBA is you have to adjust from game to game. And right now, these officials are calling any incident of a moving screen.
Boy, that is their focus tonight, isn't it? Milicic now looking in, gets it to Howard, who's come in. Howard digs it out. Howard goes up with it. Amari was there to kind of intimidate the shot. So Howard and Amari back at each other again. Out it comes to Diaw. Diaw's been so good with a shot, he gets a bounce. Diaw is now 8 of 11. 16 points, 8 rebounds, 11 assists.
He's going to get his triple double. There's no doubt about it. This game is highly contested right now.
9-point lead. Dwight Howard tonight has had 8 points, only 2 rebounds. So he's had a couple of lackluster games thus far against the Suns. We documented the one earlier this year, and Dooley now has started to take over. It was Nelson earlier, now Dooley.
And that's what they needed. They needed the fire to go with Nelson, but Nelson put his own fire out by getting in foul trouble.
Oh, what a play by L.B. Barbosa. Beautiful floating drive inside. Barbosa with 12 points.
Now it's time to get separation. Suns defensively been very good over the last month or so by just shutting teams down in crunch time. They have to get the job done now.
Suns defense is very underrated. There's been some good things starting to develop as the season wears on. Into Milicic, backing in on Diaw, and that was a nice spin move. Doesn't go. Suns come up with it. And that's the 9th rebound for Diaw. He's 1 rebound away from the triple-double. 6:45 left in the game. Barbosa outside, gets it now to Bell. Bell back to Leandro. That's a 3. Rebound is clear by Dooley. Grant Hill getting ready to come back into the Magic lineup.
Yeah, they're happy where they are. I mean, they probably thought they was going to get blowed out in this game, and Nelson got hot, and all of a sudden, the attitude and the confidence level has picked up.
This is a good basketball team, no question. We knew that record-wise. They're the surprise in the East. Nelson checked that. Dooley missing. Rebound is cleared by Barbosa, heading out to Nash. Nash driving in, and he's going to be fouled. The Warriors could do nothing with him. And so now Nelson's going to come back in, playing with 5 fouls. Also, Grant Hill will re-enter the game for the Magic. That foul is on Arroyo. His 2nd foul, side out. Let's go back to that play by LB.
I mean, just quick penetration, and he got it up and over a very good shot blocker in Milicic, and Howard was in the area.
101-92. Coming into this game, the Magic was 3rd in points allowed, allowing just over 91 a game. The Suns at 101 right now. Out it comes to Diaw. Challenges Milicic. Tough shot. Got it. Nope. They're not going to count it. They're going to have offensive interference on Stoudemire. That ball, I think, was going in.
It maybe, but Amari jumped, and he knew that if he didn't attempt to tip it in right then and there, that he wouldn't get that chance again. And I think the ball was off.
I think you're right.
The ball was off.
The shows that. And so, no basket. So the Suns still have some work to do.
Welcome to my casa. It's your boy, B. Can. This here's my foyer. This is my game room. This right here is my new suede couch.
To the pool, baby.
These are my ladies. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Hey, man, who are you?
Steve.
You part of the crew?
No, I'm just here for the Bud Light.
Who gave you that? When did you give them that?
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
Yeah, this is where I spend most of my... Man, put down my papaya!
That stealing is wrong and unnecessary. Now that Jack has two sausage egg and cheese or two bacon egg and cheese biscuits for just $2.
Come on, you ruffian.
And remember, it's only for a limited time.
Dad, what are you dreaming about?
Work stuff.
Coming up after tonight's game on Quest Suns Live, all your game highlights and analysis. We'll break down the action and get an in-depth look at the keys to the game, plus players and coaches' reactions from the post-game news conference. Quest Suns Live, tonight after the Suns game.
He's one of the most feared enforcers in the NHL, but off the ice, this Coyote's kindness runs very deep.
I'm not this big fight person.
A revealing conversation with the real George LaRocque. In my own words, George LaRocque, Wednesday night at 6:30.
The class of 82, the Trophy Broncos, and Tom Leander there with all of his teammates.
Yeah, I wonder if that water he has. And you know his nickname in high school was the Weasel.
The Weasel.
I wonder what that meant.
Tonight's Powerball jackpot, an estimated $155 million. Check for the winning numbers at ArizonaLottery.com. It's time now for the Powerball Power Play. And that's he, isn't it, 35?
Yeah, well, no, that's where he was on the bench all the time. Here's the play right here. Sean Marion inside. The great pass from Boris Diaw and the quick elevation from the Matrix.
So, 5:55 to go. This is going to be quite a finish. The Suns up 101-92. They just cannot shake this Magic team. It's taken a remarkable effort by the Suns. Six guys in double figures. Boris Diaw, a rebound away from a triple-double. Howard, double-team, gets it out now to Grant Hill. Hill has really not been a factor in this game. Goes in, doesn't get the shot to go, but reloads.
Wow.
And Hill now with 6 points.
In a game where contact has been basically a foul,
yes.
That time Hill didn't get it.
They let him play, didn't they?
Well, that's Grant Hill. You know, he's very well respected.
Diaw outside now brings it over to Amari. Amari with all the foul difficulty, and he's going to be fouled as Doolin got a piece of it. And that will be the third team foul against the Magic. So the Suns will take it side out, 5:17 left. Like Amari kind of holding on to his elbow a little bit after that foul, as he'll be all right. Marion will inbound. Brings it into Diaw. 10 on the shot clock. Bell using Diaw as a shield. Now comes around. 5 on the shot clock. Diaw goes in. He's fouled. Diaw's really taken the ball to the hole well tonight.
Yeah, he's made up his mind. And sometimes you wonder what keys Boris start to be overly aggressive as he has been tonight. You'd like to see that obviously more often.
Diaw at the line now. His first hit of the night. 1 of 2 for television's best in-depth weekly coverage. And exclusive access to the Phoenix Suns as they battle for an NBA title. Be sure to check out the Suns Insider every Monday night at 6:30 and 10 p.m. only on FSN Arizona. Here's the triple-double watch, if you will.
Yeah. The triple-double every game he steps on the floor. I mean, he has that ability to get it done.
Turkoglu's come back into the ballgame now for the Magic, and the shot will not go. Suns are 9 of 12 from the free throw line. 102-94. Stoudemire and Howard going after each other inside. They get it in low to Howard. There's not much you can do when you get it that deep.
No, I'm telling you, he is what I call dirt strong. That means you're not moving.
10 points now for Howard. Amari has 12. Nash brings it out to Diaw. Into the corner to Bell. 3. No. And Turkoglu comes down with a rebound. Maybe a very scary finish. This guy has been really something. Jameer Nelson brings it out to Turkoglu. Turkoglu face up jumper. And it's 102-98.
Yeah, they're right there. I mean, you know, if they could have had a perception to say, hey, we're down 4 with 4:20 to go, in the fourth, they would have taken it.
Well, Nash now trying to orchestrate something. Gets it to Marion. Marion goes in, blocked. Looks like Grant Hill got a piece of it. It'll be off of the Magic. Suns will get it with 8 seconds to shoot.
You know, when you're on a winning streak, you know, it gets to a point where sometimes you become a little lax because you get full of yourself. Been there, done it. And the Suns right now, they're in a battle.
And there's Marinetta blocked by Howard. We talked about how good this defensive effort has been all year for Orlando. Hill misses. Nash went up with Howard, and Howard pushed him off and just ripped the ball away.
Yeah, all of a sudden now, they're allowed to play physical. And that's the adjustment you have to make in an NBA game.
Turkoglu backing in. Now they call the foul on Turkoglu. Elbowing Roger Bell, who was hanging tough defensively.
And the official was right there. And so Turkoglu really can't complain about that at all. The official right there with the good angle, and Turkoglu turned right in, took the punch on the chest of Roger Bell.
And so we're going to take a break. It's crunch time here at the Purple Palace. Suns up by 4. Roger Bell and the Suns trying to keep the string alive.
Gravity will propel this Lexus IS over 4,000 feet in a matter of seconds. This Lexus IS will attempt to cover the same distance even faster. The 306 horsepower Lexus IS 350. So much for gravity. See your Valley Lexus dealer.
Welcome back to Push the Right Button. Go ahead, Rosa. Apparently you pressed the Launch Your Ex-Husband button. Cool. But you should have pressed the Spin button instead. Tell her why, Bob.
Rosa, Casino Arizona slots pay out over $122,000 every 30 minutes, more than any other casino in Arizona.
Sorry, Rosa, but I know you'll enjoy those decorative couch covers. All right. Thanks for playing. See you next time.
Is now infected. They'll soon trace it back to you. Good luck finding a new job.
Congratulations! Want to get away? Now you can. Just go to southwest.com for Southwest Airlines' $99 internet specials from Phoenix to select cities in the Northwest.
You are now free to move about the country.
It is crunch time here. 346, 102, 98, the Suns. Tonight's High Flyers feature. Presented by Southwest Airlines, official airline of the NBA and your Phoenix Suns. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom, and we've got some plays to show you.
Go up and get it, Amari Stoudemire, and then the White Howard. And Amari, the gift. The ball falls to the floor, and Steve Nash on the break to the Masons, the quick dunk right inside, and then Howard getting his fill of dunking. And Amari Stoudemire, the top three dunkers in the NBA, at work. And Sean Marion finishes it over the top.
Well, you know, at the start of the night, we talked about these two powerful young men. And here's what they've done thus far. Stoudemire's been a lot of foul trouble. He's played 27 minutes. Howard has played only 25 minutes. So the two kind of in a standoff right now.
Yeah, they've negated each other, no doubt about it.
102-98. 3.5 minutes left in the game. They're trying to double-team the ball out of Nash's hands. DL back to Steve. Free ball by Steve. No. Rebound by Howard.
Yeah, he released that real quick. Maybe a little quicker than what he would like. The defender running right at him.
So the Suns need a stop. They need to get this defense cranked up right now. Nelson, who had the hot hand and then had to go out with a foul trouble. Turkoglu looking inside. 3 seconds in the lane against the Magic. That's huge.
Yeah, I mean, you know, they've had a couple opportunities now to get this lead below 4, and they're making mistakes by this really unforced turnover.
That'll be the 12th turnover. The Suns have 16 tonight. Here is Diaw looking in against Turkoglu. Approaching 3 minutes left to go. Good defense. Diaw just says, I'll just shoot it. And he hits it. Diaw with 19 points. His season high is 21.
Yeah, and they're all coming by the fact that they don't think Boris is going to take the shot. They're giving him that opportunity.
104-98. Dueling inside to Howard. Howard double team. Dribbling it out is Dueling again. 10 on the shot clock. They re-enter the pass. Hill to Nelson. Nelson had the hot hand. Does he still have it? He does. Another three by Jameer Nelson.
You got to make him put it down.
I guess so.
I mean, he's just standing there. I mean, he's not even putting it down. He's just measuring and shooting.
We have a three-point game now. Here is Bell dribbling out with 2:21 left. He out going inside. Changes his movement up. Gets it to Amari. Amari then can't finish. A wrestling match inside, and we've got a foul against Stoudemire. And so Amari has picked up his fifth.
I don't know what happened after the play, but again, as I said, Howard and Amari have been going at it all game long, and Amari looked frustrated inside. Got too deep where he couldn't elevate over the top.
Yeah, because earlier Howard looked like he had a hold of Amari. But you're right, we turned away, and all of a sudden, the official spotted the foul on Amari. So Amari now with five, Marion with five, and Nelson with five in the game. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Turkoglu wanted a three. Goes to the hole instead over Amari. Howard tried to follow, and it comes out to Grant Hill.
Sometimes it's just okay to just lay it in.
Woo.
You know, you try to dunk it so hard, it just comes right out.
Well, I tell you, this is going to be some finish. Here's Howard backing in on Amari. And an off-balance shot. Amari playing good defense. Comes down to the rebound.
Yeah, not the guy you want to go to in front.
And trying to feed Sean, just couldn't quite get to it. And so the turnover gives it back to the Magic. That was so close to being a spectacular play.
Yeah, and some people might say why. But because it's a high percentage shot, those two guys work that play as well as anything. You can't get a higher percentage shot.
Nelson brings it up the floor. The Magic down by three. A minute 21 left to go. Dueling looking in. Dumps it into Howard. In pass. Grant Hill keeps it alive. Gets it over to Turkoglu. 3 seconds. And Hedo can't get it. Rebound by Nash.
Yeah, good rotation by Steve Nash that time defensively. Was not going to allow Hedo to take the three. Wanted him to step inside the line.
Nash with 8 assists. 20 points in the ballgame. Just picked up his fourth rebound. Spreading the floor now with 55 seconds left. Suns with a three-point lead. Bell into the corner to Marion. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Nash going in and doesn't get it. Marion tried to follow tip. Nash just a little awkward that time on his move inside.
Well, he normally makes that. I mean, it just didn't go for him that time. I mean, you give him 10 tries, he'll make 9. That time didn't go.
And so we've got a timeout. 42.5 seconds left in the game. Suns up by 3, but they've got a battle on their hands.
Flying to the LA area for business? If these 45 reasons don't convince you to fly Southwest Airlines nonstop to the LA area, maybe this will. With our internet specials, you can fly to the LA area for just $49 one way. Purchased by January 22nd.
You are now free to move about the country.
All Night Pet Store. Got the idea from Jack. He says you got to offer your customers anything, anytime.
No sleeping.
A Jack in the Box, that might mean a burger for breakfast or French toast sticks at midnight. For me, it might be a poodle at 2 a.m.
Are you a laundromat?
No. Need a hamster?
Order anything on the menu, anytime. From the guy who wrote the book.
The two-time MVP missing a shot a moment ago. Here's the timeout situation. The Suns have two full and a 20. The Magic have one full timeout, and the Suns have a foul to give.
Yeah, and they have to be selective on it, especially when Dueling, Nelson, or Turkoglu have the ball, because those are their 3 3-point shooters right there. Grant Hill, not a great 3-point shooter, but he will take one a time or another. But those are the main three guys, Gary, they really have to pay attention to. And believe me, they're going to take a look at that three.
So here we go. 24 seconds on the shot clock, 42 on the game clock, 42.5 to be exact. Grant Hill, a very smart player, crafty veteran, will inbound now for the Magic. Suns trying to stop it air and keep their winning streak alive. Out it comes to Nelson. John Marion comes out to pick him up. Off to Turkoglu. 15 on the shot clock. Hill's going to go inside and blocked from behind by Marion. Marion got a piece of it and then came down with a rebound.
Sean Marion again.
A huge play, and then Dooling fouls Nash with 21 seconds, and they're over the team foul limit.
So you can't teach that. I mean, that's instinctive, and that's what Sean Marion is. He's an instinctive player. He comes off of his man and comes from behind, thus surprising Grant Hill, who thought he had an easy chippy. He really did. And Sean Marion, unselfish as he always is, came from behind.
And who would you rather have at the line than Steve Nash? He just hit that one.
Now, the only thing we'd like to see in the finish of this game, obviously, is the Suns win. But Boris Diaw getting one more rebound.
I agree. But we'll take the win first.
We'll take the win.
Here is Nash.
I'm greedy.
Hit both of them. 106-101. Nash with 22 points. Now to hurry up mode, the Magic. They're going to have to launch a three. Turkoglu will try one. And the rebound by Amari. Amari digs it out. And the Suns are going, it looks like, extend their winning streak to 9 in a row. And they'll go to 28-8. This crowd loves it.
Not pretty, but effective. And this is the NBA. And you're not going to blow everyone out. It's a 48-minute game. The Magic playing, as their record indicates. They play hard. They don't give up. But the Suns found a way, again, as they always do, to close out a victory.
And so Nash back at the free throw line, 4 of 5. The Suns, if they win this one, which it looks like they will, they'll go to 16-1 against the Eastern Conference. And head out to go to Memphis and then Houston. Here's Arroyo coming into the ball game now as Nelson fouled out. That was his sixth foul, sending Nash to the line. Ryan Hill taking his time, making the change, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
And Nash strokes it nicely. How about Nash? 21 assists Thursday and now 23 points tonight.
Well, you know, that's why I'm saying you can't defend him because great players take what you give them. And that's why his stats might change from game to game because of it.
And we're going to have a timeout called by the Magic. They have a 20. That's all they've got. They do not have a full timeout. So it's 107-101. Well, you said it well. You sometimes don't have artistic success, but it's in the W column, Eddie, and that's what's important.
Well, the bottom line is the win. As I said, I mean, you're not going to have a beautiful game every game. In terms of blowing teams out. And Suns right now very close to overtaking the Spurs in terms of point differential. But, you know, a challenge like this is always good in a streak because they lost their losing streak a few weeks ago to the Wizards because I thought they relaxed a little bit, although they were tired.
Yeah.
But I thought they kept a swagger that didn't measure up to what the Wizards brought to them. And all of a sudden, Gilbert Arenas and Caron Butler got them a victory. Well, the Suns should have learned from that, and I think they have. And like I said, the Orlando Magic is a very good basketball team.
So the Suns will go out for 2 games on the road. They come back for 2, and then have a 5-game road trip to close out this month. And right now, they're trying to close out the Magic with 8 seconds to go and sweep the season series.
And I told you, the only thing that's going to make me feel good about driving home tonight is my man 3D gets this rebound.
All right. And the reason for that, he would have his 6th triple-double of his career.
It's not going to help you guarding the guy taking
it out
of bounds.
Where's he going to get the rebound? Here it comes down to Dooley. Dooley will try a 3. The ball up and tipped out. And Nash saved it. And that's the end of the game. So the Suns get it done. They now are 17-3 at home. They've won 7 in a row at home. 16 of the last 17 here.
A dominant basketball team proving to everyone that they're just thought on them winning the championship was true. After a 1-5 start, this right now is one of the better teams in the league.
No question about it. Thanks to Tom Delnos, our statistician, Sheila Simpson, our stage manager, Bob Pockman in charge of all the audio. Our next Suns game on FSN Arizona's Friday against the Portland Trailblazers. Suns Live begins at 6:30. Now for much more on tonight's game, including Mike D'Antoni's press conference and reaction from inside the locker room. It's time for Suns Live from the Bud Light Paseo with your host, Brad Steinke, and Tom Chambers. Let's send it to them.